And every day she looks like she's deteriorating faster as God steps in. Like plagues visited upon Egypt and finally upon Pharaoh's house. You will only see it intensify, ladies and gentlemen, because this country has had providence on its side, always has. This is a foreign globalist takeover. And there are still people that love God and love the Republic and love the great experiment that is this system. And so, as I say every day, it was the best of times, the worst of times. We have a dichotomy in front of us, in our hands. We have a parallel system. We are at that proverbial crossroads right now. And the rigging of Donald Trump speeches where they cut live feeds when he talks about Hillary being a communist Chinese agent, or he talks about Hillary being the founder of ISIS, which is a term I coined. I'm quite proud of that, which she is. I wouldn't call her the founder of ISIS if she wasn't the founder of ISIS. Look it up for yourself. And so now we have more videos of her on the podium, at the stage, suddenly not knowing what planet she's on. Talk about judgment. But before we celebrate too much, and I don't normally celebrate people's ailments, but it's like God, you know, cursing Herod or something for the things he's done. I just don't want this great evil to be in full control of the nation. But at the same time, imagine her in the Oval Office as she degenerates and rots in front of everyone, what she'll pull and what her handlers will pull. I mean, this is a very satanic move by the elite to put this witch in power. We'll be back. It is Tuesday, the 9th day of August, 2016. We're only 91 days out right now from the 2016 presidential election that is undoubtedly the most important election in this nation's history. Hands down, it's not debatable. Whether you're talking about total control of the Supreme Court, or whether you're talking about the future of our borders themselves, or the fact that we're going under international, multinational, unelected trade boards established by private corporations. The all-out attack on language, the all-out attack on the family, the all-out attack on normal human activity and agrarian farming activities. Look at DrudgeReport.com. It says it all. This morning, I was doing research for the show, and I said to myself, when I get in today, I've got to have them make a bunch of liners that have Twilight Zone music. I mean, we already have that, but I want liners. In fact, I even started telling them to bring this last night, but I definitely want it now, that just has the countdown every day, 91 days, 90 days, with Twilight Zone music playing in the background, because it's the only way to describe it. That's what this is. Every day, it becomes more Twilight Zone. And then I go to DrudgeReport.com. Twilight Zone. Orlando, terrorist dad for Clinton, cheers Hillary at rally, said God will punish gays, supported Taliban. Now, this isn't his dad saying this 20, 30 years ago in Afghanistan. This is his dad has a YouTube show in Arabic, in Pashtun. And his son went to the mosque where they preached on video. We have the clips in English. Because we love the homosexuals. We kill them. It is the humane thing to do for Allah. Some weird creepoid imam. And then they invert reality and blame Donald Trump. I mean, it's all Twilight Zone. Because that's what it is. And his dad is at the rally with this big yellow sign praising Hillary. Twilight Zone, Orlando terrorist dad for Clinton, cheers Hillary at rally, said God will punish gays, supported Taliban. And he's there on the local news, on local NBC. Hillary Clinton makes the biggest investment since World War II. Good for national security. Ex-CIA chief Morrell, Hillary told the truth about Benghazi. Gun control laws. Here's this guy with his whole family running refugee programs. The father-in-law of the shooter, remember, the Pulse nightclub. 50-something dead. And then you never even hear apologies out of this guy's mouth. And then he's in an Orlando suburb at a Hillary rally. But wait, it gets worse. Infowars.com shows video of Hillary with only 171 people turning up for her rally in Florida. In an empty aircraft hangar, but the press crops the photos to make it look like she has a giant audience. Media photoshops Hillary crowd to make her audience look bigger. Only 171 people turn up for Clinton's rally in Florida. They crop it. And in the crowd behind her is Sadiq Mateen, father of Omar Mateen, the Pulse nightclub mass murderer, who has nothing to do with Islam. Oh, look, Al-Qaeda just hit again. Oh, look, ISIS just hit again. Yesterday, hundreds killed in different suicide bombings in the Middle East and Central Asia. And it's like, oh, ISIS hits again? That's the group that has nothing to do with Islam. Here is the shooter's father talking about how wonderful Hillary is.
Hillary Clinton speaking to a crowd in Kissimmee, just south of Orlando. Supposed to be talking jobs, but started off paying tribute to those affected by the Pulse nightclub shooting.
And I know how many people, family members, loved ones, and friends are still grieving.
Notice the man right behind Secretary Clinton with a mustache and wearing a red hat. That's the father of the Orlando shooter. Just hours later, by chance, we ran into him at a rest stop on the way back to West Palm Beach.
Clinton is good for the United States versus Donald Trump.
He wanted to do an interview and showed us a sign he made for Hillary Clinton.
So tell us why you wanted to stop and talk now.
Hit pause. Just stop. Why does Drudge call this Twilight Zone? Why was I yesterday telling crew I want Twilight Zone intros and outros for the election? And I want to be able to tailor them every day that has new weirdness that's going on, new bizarreness, and then finally have a big compendium one that's like 10 minutes long right before the election of just all the insanity. On day 91, this happened. On day 90, this happened. On day 90 or 89, this happened. On day 91... the Orlando mass murderer Islamist's dad shows up for Clinton. And it only gets weirder from there. Just like Khan. Oh, the poor person whose son died in Iraq, who set up a Sharia law journal and law center to integrate Sharia law specifically as its founding mission over Western jurisprudence, which is a merger of European and Anglo-Saxon common law and Jewish law. That's what it is. And the two are so close, that's why they integrated so well. Not the same as Islamic law. And what we're sitting here looking at is total crazy land. I mean, we are overrun. I used to hear 10 years ago by people, they're putting Islamists in at the FBI and CIA and NSA and the military, and they're putting them in as police chiefs all over Europe, and they're going to take over with them. I'm like, oh, shut up. I know there's a lot of radical Muslims and bad stuff over there, but we shouldn't be stirring them up, and we shouldn't be over there. And, you know, this is all exaggerated to take our rights away. I didn't know that they were actually setting them up to basically take over and be the enforcers and henchmen, because they'll just go blow themselves up or kill themselves for the establishment anytime they're given an order to do it. The liberals have finally found their army. And, of course, they're not liberals. And then indicative, emblematic, archetypal, illustrative, declarative, underlining, emblazoning, spotlighting the rotting establishment is Hillary in bozo land. There's a new video, we're going to hit you after the break, of her on the campaign trail just totally forgetting who she is, and just like my grandmother, who's 91, until about a year ago, was always there. Sometimes you'll be a go visitor, and she'll just suddenly, for about a minute, not know who she is. And then suddenly she's right back. Hillary Clinton is now doing this on TV everywhere she goes and stumbling around and looks like a bag lady. She doesn't just look old. I wouldn't care if she was 70 years old and knew what she was doing, 80 years old. It's that she is doddering. Phyllis Schlafly, at what, 90 years old, is more together than Hillary Clinton when you see her give a speech. Her body's frail, but her brain is still 95% there compared to the incredible intellect she was. She's now just an intellect, a strong intellect. Hillary is gone. Ain't there, ladies and gentlemen, whacked out of her brain. And you can tell she's on drugs, speed, you name it. That's why she can get charged up and just be all angry. That's why she can't have press conferences. That's why she's like, I'm sorry, I got short-circuited. Oh, Benghazi. I mean, her first press conference in a year. And then you've got this guy who doesn't even have any shame. Here's the big issue. Omar Mateen's daddy, Sadiq, the famous Taliban jihadi brought over here by the CIA in the late 1980s, this is all, he's driving around his Mercedes, his modern Mercedes, and getting out of his $85,000 car to hold up his Hillary sign. What on earth is going on here? Orlando Terrace father cheers at Hillary Clinton rally, calls for gun control, when his son had a Homeland Security clearance and legal guns. I mean, under his system, under his beliefs, I'm skipping the break. Under all of that, network break, I can do it. In fact, I'm going to be honest. Before I punched up Drudge and saw that, I was going to come on air and say, I almost can't even do this show anymore. I'm going to skip this break, guys. We'll go out with the next segment with Twilight Zone. Because it's getting so crazy that it's almost like even sitting up here on air and laughing at all this and playing videos and saying what's coming next almost turns us into sick spectators who are tied down watching little demons eat our toes off. And we're like, look at that little demon. He just ate my big toe, and now he's chewing at my heel. Oh, look, I'm bleeding all over the table. Oh, another one just climbed up, and I'm chained down. And, oh, look, they're fighting with each other. Look how evil they are. Doesn't matter. We're chained down with them eating our feet. Now they're metaphorically climbing up with sewing needles and jamming them in our eyes. And we're like, look at this country. It'll never wake up when we're all the body politic being attacked, being diseased, being overrun. Do you know how over the top it is to bring in millions of people a year over the southern border alone that have diseases like TB and black plague and leprosy, which have now made comebacks? They were eradicated. Black plague, bubonic plague, wet leprosy. It's now, they're having to set up leper colonies in Texas and Florida. And the CDC tries to keep them quiet, but they're there. Leper colonies, boys and girls. They'll let people in, and there's the Border Patrol, their gloves and their masks, because I've talked to them, and then this is listed in literature. They're like, oh, this guy's got wet leprosy, nose rotting off. They don't give them medical treatment. They let them in. But forget leprosy, that's still rare. Drug-resistant TB, where the antibiotics that might be able to control it, not get rid of it, cause liver failure and kidney failure in most people within two or three uses. They're taking them and putting them in high schools and middle schools and elementary schools and colleges all over the country. And not even testing them. Oh, but don't worry. The high schools and colleges want to make you take 50-something vaccines, including meningitis vaccines, that have been linked to all sorts of medical problems. That's okay. And upwards of 22% of the refugees have TB now. That's Associated Press. And they don't even test them. That'd be culturally rude, because then what will we do with you? No, come here, Akeem, Ali, whatever their name is. Come here and sit right down next to little Jenny. Why? 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 Because they're at war with us, ladies and gentlemen. The globalists are bringing down the West as we speak. The bare minimum is you would give treatment to these poor souls, like they did at Ellis Island. Statue of Liberty. Oh, you got to come in, but you got cured of your disease first or shipped back. Give me, you're tired, you're hungry, you're diseased. So, this is the arrogance. Let's back that local NBC newscast up, and I'll, at least they saw the horror and the bizarreness of it. National media is like, well, see, he cares. He wants gun control. He's sorry for what his son did. No, he's not. He's there as a jihadi who has his own YouTube show, who pushes Sharia law and everything that the imam that his son followed was saying. And it's outrageous that the media never made an issue of his dad. And why hasn't he been deported? Deport his Taliban butt. Oh, no, that would be mean. So now he's so arrogant and on such a power trip because, you know, Trump's 15 points behind now. Why not make it 20? If it, we can put the graph back there. Why not say he's 3,000 points behind? You could only be 100 points behind. Folks would know that was impossible, though. So they're going to tell you, oh, Trump's 15 points, 12 points. Why, Fox News has had the little coup now where they got rid of Roger Ailes, so they're not even going to have scientific polls there. They have their new news director on this morning, and he was saying, oh, yes, there's a lot of fake polls that show Trump neck and neck, but the real polls show her about 12 points ahead, and that's where she's going to win. So Trump is going to lose. And Himmer and the other anchor were like, okay, well, thank you for that information. So we put up our new poll here. This is the new Hillary Clinton poll, MSNBC poll. Another new poll shows that she was 10 points ahead. Then she was, I mean, let me look at it here, 347 points, 800 and something points. 1,465 points, then 2,727 points, and then 3,435 points is where she is today. On the 9th of August, 2016, she is 3,435 points ahead. And it's scientific. I said so, okay? Also, she had 20,000 people in Orlando. That's what the news has been reporting. Now, I'm going to show you the reality here. It's on InfoWars.com. It's still linked on Drudge. I saw it on Drudge this morning as well. Folks can go there and see it. And if you're radio listeners, you should go see this, and you should send this on to folks. Media photoshops Hillary crowd to make her audience look bigger. And they cropped it in and then also added and repeated some of the people in there. And why not? I mean, they're fighting an evil racist. So it's okay. Why not just beef that crowd up, crop it and beef it? In reality, look at that. No one. No one. In fact, they're saying that's 150-something? 171? That isn't even that. Good Lord. This is what she has all over the country, where Sanders would have 5,000, 20,000, 30,000. She would have 1,000 max. We've been at the rallies where she'd have 1,000 people. It'd be on the news. More than 20,000 showed up today to see Hillary. This is total state-run media. And it makes my head spin. Let's go back to Omar Mateen, killed 50-plus people. Here's his daddy, Sadiq.
Just hours later, by chance, we ran into him at a rest stop on the way back to West Palm Beach.
Clinton is good for the United States versus Donald Trump.
He wanted to do an interview and showed us a sign he made for Hillary Clinton.
So tell us why you wanted to stop and talk now.
Well,
I
feel like...
I cannot believe he has the nerve again to go to a rally where she's invoking the dead, ignoring Islam's involvement, and then he has the nerve to blame our Second Amendment, our birthright, because he wants his quarry disarmed. He wants his demi. That's when the Muslims start taking over, the subgroups have to pay tribute, and that's what we become. Meanwhile, at the Olympics, we get to see the Brazilian volleyball team. Oh, my God, those women are just, I think Brazilian women, maybe Eastern European, I don't know, but they're hot. Mexican TV stars, just, I mean, I'm just appreciating God's creations. I mean, can't we all? You've got juxtaposed the Egyptian women totally covered up in Teletubby uniforms. Just like in Europe, they're banning water parks, you know, wearing bikinis, you got to wear burka outfits. That's actually happening. And we've got the German team. They look really good, too. The Brazilian team, that's what I like, is athletic, God's creations. That's the way to go. And then you've got the poor Muslim women in their hooded outfits. I mean, I really feel sorry for them. I really, really do. But the particular one is them with the Brazilian team. It's something else. I mean, look at those goddesses, God's creation. And then you've got next to them these poor women having to cover themselves up. I'm going to stop right there, please. Let's go back to Mr. Taliban, who has his own YouTube channel, his own YouTube show, agreeing with everything basically his son pushed. Here it is.
You, why I stopped to talk to you, because it's very important for the United States of America, especially the election. I was invited by Democratic Party.
Just like a come support Hillary, just a regular chain email or a personal invitation?
So it came out, I'm a member, so... As a member, I get the invitation, so it's nothing particular about it.
What went into your decision about going to this event right near Orlando where this Pulse nightclub shooting happened?
I wish, because I spoke a lot about that, and I wish that my son joined the army and fought ISIS and destroyed ISIS. That would be much better.
Did Hillary Clinton's campaign know that you were going to that event and sitting right directly behind her?
It's a Democratic Party, so everybody can join.
Do you think that some people will be surprised to know and to
I'm
see
sorry,
that
this
you
is
were
just
there
too much.
In Orlando or near Orlando?
Why they should be surprised?
We'll be back. I can't handle it. Oh my gosh, I just can't handle it anymore. These people are crazy. Imagine being the mainstream media and basically going to meetings with the Attorney General at the time, Eric Holder. We're at an RTF banquet, national meeting. It's on C-SPAN. And he gets up and he says, listen, it's not enough to just sometimes go out of the Second Amendment to repeal it. I want you to hammer it every segment constantly. I want brainwashing. I want brainwashing. And you fast forward to today, that's why, and I keep going back to this because it's so central, and I'm going to put a special report together on this showing Gruber and showing the State Department head spokesman we played yesterday and all these others, Gibbs and others, where they just make jokes about, yeah, we lie to the filth. And they're so stupid, and it's so much fun to screw them and triple their prices. Oh, we've got some young college kids here learning about truth and justice and democracy. And then you've got total weirdo behavior with this guy obviously out of his mind. in my view, Sadiq Mateen, his son killed 50 plus people. They're like, do you think it's a little weird you're here with Hillary and, you know, your son and all the rest of this? And she's having a memorial for the dead, pushing gun control, and you're here. No, nothing weird. No, no, no. You know, don't show your face, buddy, unless you're there apologizing. But no, he has a YouTube show. He does radio and TV interviews. We've played them in Pashtun with translations saying the same crap his son said. And I'll tell you what's so whacked out about these freaks is it's been confirmed the son had a whole bunch of homosexual encounters and was running around on those apps going wild. Talk about total mental patients. And people say, well, see, that's not Islam. See, that's why he was conflicted. No, that's what they do in Islam. It has the highest rates of homosexual sex. Look it up. Do people know that Islam pushes that black people aren't humans and calls them raisin heads? And I don't want to get off on some jag about Islam. I knew all this stuff 20 years ago. Okay, but I wasn't wanting to have a clash of civilizations. I wasn't wanting to go down this path. I know a lot of these people just want to reform. And, you know, Christianity and some of its past has been barbaric as well. People have used it, misappropriated. I get it, okay? But the brand of Islam we've got running us over right now is super screwed up and incredibly oppressive and illiberal. Anti-liberal. And I just want to indict the Democratic Party, and I want to indict all of you that are apologists for Islam, because you really are bad people. And they're so arrogant and so disconnected. As far as I could look, maybe I'm wrong, but weren't there national issues that Omar Mateen's dad, Sadiq, never really apologized? Kind of like in this newscast on NBC Local. In Orlando, he's come down from New York for this. And he's there. He's not even from there, last time I checked. And he goes, oh, I wish he wouldn't have done what he did. I wish he would have gone and killed ISIS instead. That would have been better. So some half-ass apology, excuse me, I don't want to use French here, I apologize. I was kind of having a Hillary moment last time when they said, hey, boss, are you mad or something? Because you laid your head down, that's what I do when I get, and I'm like, no, I do not know how to respond to this anymore. I have hit a wall with weirdness. Hillary obviously is completely insane. She obviously has trouble standing straight up. She comes back to debates late. She looks like she's wearing a diaper. You know, she's going to need one. She reportedly is having seizures like on the hour. And then you swallow yourself. I'm not knocking folks that are in that position. I'm just telling you, the first lady is either wearing bulletproof underwear or she's got a diaper on, which shows she's incontinent. And I just, what a symbol for us, a mentally ill, deranged tyrant who's wearing a crap-filled diaper, who's having seizures constantly, and the media is trying to hide it. And then calling it right-wing BS that she's sick. Look at Bill Clinton. Look at photos of him in full light. He looks like a dead body. I've seen dead bodies. I've had dead family members that are 80 years old look better than that. And that's when they've been dead for 3 days. I don't know what to do at this time. And then they're photoshopping everywhere. Just like we said, we can't find Hillary supporters unless I go to the rich part of town, a very small called Tarrytown in Austin, and you'll see some of her signs. That's it. There are Bernie Sanders stickers everywhere in Austin. There are Donald Trump stickers all over the place. There are more Bernie. You go outside Austin, there are Donald Trump stickers all over the place. We go all over the country. Donald Trump, Bernie Sanders, everywhere. Hillary, nowhere. The exit polls show it. She stole the nomination. We already know all this. That's what's so crazy about this. We already know this. And so all they're doing is positioning us now with a whole spectrum of polls that they've never done it like this. AP, Reuters, you name it. Where Trump, even with fixed methodology, went 10 points ahead on her. 10 points. And they went, whoa. Changed the methodology, sample 15% more Democrats than Republicans. Shoot her ahead, not even 12 points. In fact, some polls show them, even the new Reuters poll shows her only 3 points ahead. So they are panicking because that means Hillary must be down at like 25% or something. Almost every blue-collar Democrat I talk to goes, I'm going for Trump. I'm sick of Hillary, and I'm sick of the Bushes and the establishment. And most of them wanted Sanders. Sanders was the real candidate. That guy could have been president. In fact, I'll be honest with you. As much as I disagree with Sanders' endgame and what he wants to do at the end of the road, I've looked at the real demographics. I think Bernie Sanders would have beat Donald Trump in a head-to-head real election. I just tell it like it is, folks. And I study. And a lot of people, insiders, agree with me. Bernie Sanders, America's gone socialist. America's got major problems. But at least they're trying to go after the big bankers. At least the socialists get that there's a super rich that's screwing everybody. But they think it's class warfare. They think free market's the problem. It's a rigged market that's the problem. But we talk to Sanders people all over the country. You've seen countless interviews we did with them. Well-spoken. They know the issues. We talked to Hillary people, the ones we could finally find. We weren't trying to find people. Mark Dice isn't trying to find people that are mentally retarded. That's who her supporters are. Or they're really polished, slick con artist types. And, you know, you're at the bar with them going, yeah, so I just hope we get all the guns. I hope she bans them. Oh, I met with her. She's got to, you know, con everybody. But as soon as we get in, we're taking them. Oh, cheers. Oh, you like my, you know, Versace purse? It's 20 grand. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Let me go out and get my brand new Mercedes or BMW. So if you go to drudgereport.com, it's also up on Infowars.com. You can see the photos and the Photoshop right next to it. And again, this is all just part of the rigging. Doesn't matter Infowars is getting 100% more traffic than we just got 6 months ago. Doesn't matter if we're getting over 100% traffic from 6 months back, what we got the year before. Doesn't matter if we're exponentially growing and have seen 300% growth the last 2 years. 300% growth in IP addresses coming into Infowars.com, not to mention all our other platforms. 300% conservatively. And do you know, and everybody can see it. Just look at Infowars everywhere. And then you go to Amazon's Alexa.com and it says we're down by 80%. Oh, and so is Drudge. It'd be like Cassius Clay knocking somebody out in the second round, and then they say Cassius Clay lost when the guy he beat is bleeding on the ground. And you say, well, at least we've got all the traffic, and they're going down, we're going up. The first thing they do is start minimizing you and cutting off your funding so that advertisers don't want to come to you before they send the government and the regulators after you to shut you down. And that's what they're already doing and saying they're going to do. So here's the deal. Do not take this broadcast for granted, because they don't want you to see how we can go out and find photos online of what was really at the Hillary event and then show you the news and then show you how it's photoshopped. They don't want us to get a local NBC reporter that slipped through the cracks and actually reported that this jihadi was there. They don't like that InfoWars takes it one level. The White House has even written about this. Media Matters, that's who runs it. We take it to one level, and then Drudge pushes it to another level, and then they can't contain it, and then they've got a problem. And see, then she'll lose another 5 points from this. She'll be down at 25%. Now they've got to jack polls even harder. Now, what happens on election night when 80% go in for Trump and then people are there exiting and everybody's for Trump? Oh, you're going to, and then Trump's going to challenge it, isn't he? Let me explain something to you. And I know most of our listeners know this, but Hillary Clinton, as the nominee, should have 10,000 people per event, even in small towns. Trump is having 50 to 75,000 in big cities, and he should. I used to go hear Ronald Reagan speak, and it'd be like 100,000 at Fair Park or wherever in Dallas on my dad's shoulders. And she's got 171 people at her event, according to the Secret Service. 171. Trump goes to little towns that have 10, 15,000 people. And then everybody comes from the other towns to that sports stadium, and he'll have 15,000 people. His smallest crowds are 5,000. And to make them look small, they'll get them in a hangar. They'll get them in a stadium that holds 5,000. They'll only let 1,000 in, and then they'll pull back and say, look at his small crowd. And Trump's too smart. He goes, hey, fire marshal wouldn't let the 4,000 people outside in here. That's why day one he'd say, pull those cameras back. Show how many people are here. Remember that a year ago? They wouldn't show 50,000, 80,000, 20,000. See, that's why they hate Trump, because he's been in the media, he's been in business, he's been an engineer, an economist, he's seen every angle of it. He knows their games. But they'd spin and go, look at him bitching, saying the fire marshal, poor fireman, poor firefighter. Turns out the mayor was a Hillary supporter, did order it, and the same day she came and she thanked him. And it turned out the next town that did it. But guess what happens since Trump exposed it twice? They're not doing it anymore in Democrat cities. Because Trump walks right up to those fire marshals and says, I want your name. I want your badge number. I want it all. That building says right there on the entrance that this holds 10,000 people. 10,000! You're going to let them in right now. Now, he says a little bit nicer than that. But they don't have room for Trump. They don't have room for Trump unless the fire marshal shows up, because they don't want those images. Bernie Sanders, 10,000, 20,000, Trump, 15,000, 30,000, 50,000. They don't like it. Remember, tested, trusted Ted couldn't get 3,000. Marco Rubio couldn't get 300. Straw men, fake, frauds, hoaxes, garbage, bull, manipulation. Hillary's biggest rallies in like Cleveland, Ohio, 2,000. We just showed for TV viewers all of it. In fact, we should put special reports out on just this issue. By the way, I don't know how the team just put that together so fast. Bravo. This InfoWars operation, especially the crew behind the scenes, people that actually run things, the graphics, the editing, the research on the TV side and the radio/TV side, just amazing folks. And I just thank God for them. I'm very, very honored. And I'm very, very thankful to all of you that make this broadcast possible. Let me spend a few minutes talking about that. We are an information warfare system that is organic, that is real, that is extremely strong and getting stronger thanks to your prayers. We sell thousands of cutting edge products and solar panel systems and preparedness items and things that I personally use in my own personal program to be able to fund this operation. And it is so essential. And I want to thank all of you that have supported us, that you go to InfoWarsStore.com and that you check out the non-GMO heirloom open pollinated seeds. The Hillary for Prison shirts, the free shipping and specials are over, but we have 40% off on the amazing Anthroplex that is organic, super clean, extremely, extremely powerful. Just go read about what it does for yourself, whether it's stamina or whether it is libido. Anthroplex is 40% off. If you like Super Male Vitality, you're going to love Anthroplex. They work together in concert. Anthroplex has some ingredients that aren't in Super Male and vice versa. Anthroplex, the twice-daily pill formulated for men that is designed to restore your masculine foundation. It's also great for women. It's now 40% off, unprecedented, at InfoWarsLife.com. Anthroplex was created to help fight back against the attack on men and simulate natural masculine health with its own blend of unique ingredients. You can take Anthroplex by itself or pair it with Super Male Vitality for maximum effect. Start fighting back and rebuilding your foundation with Anthroplex. Visit InfoWarsLife.com and secure your bottle of Anthroplex for 40% off while supplies last. And let me tell you something. What you feel the quickest is obviously libido. That's what the reviewers say. We don't pitch this as that, but I've told the story before. I mean, when I was 40, I went to the doctor, had a big physical, all this other stuff done, and I guess this is what the doctors do. They said, hey, you want a prescription of Viagra, a prescription of Cialis? And I was like, I don't really need it, but sure, I'll try it out. Tried it out. Really, just, I just don't need it. Nothing, for me personally, nothing like Super Male Vitality. Same thing with Anthroplex. I mean, it big effect, but it takes a day. And it's just in general. It's amazing. We're back live. Joe Biggs is coming up in about 40 minutes. He has been to countless Hillary events, Trump events, you name it. And of course, I don't just believe Joe. Everybody knows this. It's a fact that you've got to get Secret Service clearance specifically to sit behind Hillary. And that those people are vetted. It's why a lot of times they're all wearing the same T-shirts or whatever, because they're from a group. Omar Mattin's daddy gets up behind Hillary in the Orlando suburb. Sadiq Mattin's gets up there. And he says he's proud of it. He says that, you know, there's no reason he shouldn't be able to do this. In fact, we're going to go back to that part and play that in a minute. Sadiq Mateen. And now they're saying, hey, that is crazy. That is insane. We didn't invite him up there. We didn't put him behind Hillary. This just shows how disconnected from reality these folks are. Joe Biggs is going to be giving us a detailed report later in the next hour, you're a veteran of this, Joe. You've been through this many, many times. I know you've tried to get behind Hillary. I guess we'll let folks have a little secret so you could unbutton your shirt and have a Hillary for prison. That stunt never worked. We'll just reveal that now. But this new lie that they didn't let him in, that's certainly a fraud, isn't it?
Yeah, it's complete and total BS. I mean, I've registered for her emails, her updates all the time, and I get an email saying, hey, there's going to be a Hillary event, there's going to be a Bernie event, a Trump event, so forth and so on, and it's free and open to the public a lot of times. And yes, you can go, but you have to look at the placement of where Sadiq Mateen was. He was standing directly behind Hillary Clinton, which means that you've got to be properly vetted to be able to be back there. Now, that usually goes to donors, people who spend a lot of money towards her campaign, and have some kind of, it's like a perk for doing that, to be able to stand there. So when I go in to cover these events, you already see that crowd behind the podium already full. It's already been selected by, you know, the certain people that they want to have there. So for them to come out, the DNC, for the Clinton campaign to say, we had no idea that he was going to be there, he wasn't invited, well, that's just a plain lie. I mean, that's something that we've got to get used to with the Clintons. It's going to be a lie. But, I mean, look at this. Look at the kind of people she keeps in her corner. You have the Khans, a guy who wants to have Sharia law above all. And then you have Sadiq Mateen, the father of Omar Mateen, who went out and killed a whole bunch of gay people.
And he does TV shows, basically.
Yes, in California. It's a pro-Pashtun show that is watched by many Pashtun Afghanis and Europeans around America and throughout Europe.
Well, I'll tell you what. Get us all that information, all that material together. We're showing it on screen right now. And come in later in the next hour. Let's do a whole report on this so we can get this out to everybody, Joe. Thanks for pointing that out.
Roger that.
And Joe's got the footage of him trying to, you know, get obviously into that group. And it's already pre-planned. It's part of the campaign. It's organized by the campaign. And the fact that they're in the news denying it is incredible. Now, I'm going to get to some more of the interview he did with NBC where he doesn't think there's a problem him being there. We're also going to show some video that I should get to now. This is a new video of Hillary having a momentary blackout and dizzy spell. Another video to add to all the other videos. Here it is.
about health care. We need to make what we've got work really well and improve it and get the costs out of an upward spiral of
Now, again, that's a short little clip. By itself, you can say it's nothing, but you add it into everything else. She clearly is having little seizures. And I have an uncle that's got epilepsy from a motorcycle accident. And the same thing with him. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen, in 70 seconds. We got a lot of other economic news. And, oh, big news on arresting climate deniers. Now, if you just joined us, I want to be very, very clear. I don't think the number one story in the world is Omar Mateen, the mass murderer from the gay Orlando nightclub that killed 50-plus people. I don't think that it's the number one story in the world that his dad showed up in a suburb of Orlando yesterday and was part of a vetted group behind Hillary Clinton, and then he went on the news and said he was, you know, basically proud of Hillary Clinton and how wonderful she is. And by that, I don't mean that story by itself is the most important, but what it's illustrative of, what it shows you, is the total disconnect and the absolute ignorance and the fact that there is such a love, such a fellow traveler attitude with the Islamicists and the Democratic Party, even though the two groups supposedly don't agree with each other on almost anything, that they would have this guy be vetted by the Secret Service and put behind her, and that he wouldn't even think that there was an issue with the fact that, hey, your son killed all these people. Is it a good thing that you're here? So I want to play that clip for folks because, again, it just shows how the establishment and even their minions are smoking their own propaganda. They're smoking their own bull. They're buying their own baloney. And that's scary because this is an establishment that's making a lot of really dangerous moves worldwide. And even mainline analysts, retired generals, foreign leaders are saying, what are you doing? Well, no one ever acted like this before from the West. And we have a bunch of people that have overthrown our institutions who still act like they're revolutionaries when they're in charge. And that's very dangerous. And the late actor Ron Silver, who's a big leftist and better known as being a producer than he was and being in films like Die Hard. He was at the Clinton's inauguration in 1993 and F-16s flew over. And this guy was so disconnected from reality, such an America hater, that he famously in front of newspaper reporters and Democrats went, how dare them fly those over and threaten us? And they went, Ron, it's okay, there are jets now. And see, that tells you everything you have to know about those people. They are just people with guns, American flags. There's just a bunch of neurotic fruits. And they just haven't lived in the real world. Here is the daddy of the nightclub killer, the mass murderer, Omar Mateen's papa at the Hillary event. Here he is.
Clinton's campaign know that you were going to that event and sitting right directly behind her?
It's a Democratic Party, so everybody can join.
Do you think that some people will be surprised to know and to see that you were there in Orlando or near Orlando?
Why they should be surprised? I love the United States, and I've been living here for a long time.
Why you be surprised? I only do TV show for Taliban and Pashtun. Family help bring in refugee, me friendy, me hook into CIA.
Then this guy was brought here. And it's just all designed in social engineering to bring in incompatible people. I mean, can we put up the photos again of the Islamic women in the Teletubby outfits? I mean, that's what they are. If you don't know what Teletubby are, they're like these little space alien things, these little hats that look like a little condom in on the back of their head, a little antenna. And, I mean, that's what these women are wearing, these Teletubby outfits. And then here they are playing these other women. And it's just like, look at the future. Look at science. Look at all the high-tech gear in those bikinis. And just all the, you know, coding and science and everything else that goes into God's amazing designs. I'm such a fan of God's artwork, I have to tell you. And then meanwhile, you've got this demonic cult covering it up. And I don't like it. Look, it's okay. I'll explain it. Fox News has got its medical team come out. We're going to play a clip of that here in just a few minutes. And said, look, she needs to release her neurology records. And I was thinking, who better to bring on? Somebody that's known Hillary Clinton, somebody who's been in the Council on Foreign Relations, somebody who was the head of psychological warfare for the State Department, co-author of many of Tom Clancy's books as well, Dr. Steve Pachenik of stevepachenik.com. He's an MD and PhD, an American psychiatrist, former State Department official, author, and publisher. So he has MIT degree as well, trained in psychiatry at Harvard and international relations at MIT. To specifically talk about Hillary, look, it always comes up in elections to say somebody's got a health problem or somebody doesn't have a health problem. And a lot of times it's a red herring. But with Hillary, every day now, she doesn't know where she's at. She suddenly starts having clearly seizures. Again, I have an uncle who's in a motorcycle accident, and you'll be sitting there with him. He'll suddenly start doing the exact same thing she does. When she was out under the bright lights at the DNC, she started doing it repeatedly. She's falling and stumbling downstairs. She looks bad. She has lesions on her tongue. Dr. Steve Pachenik isn't just a top psychiatrist. He was a board examiner and he ran entire medical facilities. And so he was also bringing up the fact that Charles Krauthammer had at one time actually worked under him in one of these programs. So to break all of this down, and Krauthammer's saying there's serious questions as well, is Dr. Steve Pachenik, doctor, specifically, go over your background for folks that may not know who you are, your curriculum background, your letters, and then let's get specifically into what you're seeing with Hillary Rodham Clinton.
Number one, my background is I went to Cornell Medical School, received my MD in 1968. Then I went to Harvard in 1971. Became a psychiatrist. At the same time, I went to MIT to receive my PhD in international relations. I became board certified, and eventually I was brought in as a board examiner in neurology and psychiatry. But in my private practice in Washington, D.C., despite also working at the State Department as a DAS under Nixon, Ford, Reagan, Bush, and others, I also treated congressmen, senators, and major politicians. I clearly won't say who. The key issue for me and why I'm grateful you brought me on the show again, and as you know, you didn't know what I was about to say, and I didn't want anybody to know, but the point of fact is the two physicians, Dr. Siegel and the other gentleman from Mount Sinai, who are on Fox News, were absolutely correct, as was Charlie Krauthammer, for demanding that we have an independent investigation of Hillary Clinton. Why do I say that? Number one, for some time now, she has had a history of seizures. One sees it. She has a hard time going up the steps. She's totally confused. And in one of the most revealing interviews that was done on Fox News, where Chris Wallace repeatedly asked her, did you or did you not commit a malfeasance or a felony with the emails? She just repeated total lies. In my business, given the fact that she's had a history of three major concussions, 1998, 2009, 2012, she'd been put on anticoagulants. And I will go over her medical record as it was written by her internist, Lisa Bardak. She evidences a serious problem of neurological and cognitive deficit in the brain, be it post-stroke syndrome, or if I said, if you have constant thrombosis in the brain, you have to look for occult tumors. Occult tumors meaning secret tumors that are in the brain, which were biopsied when she was at the Physicians and Surgeons Columbia in 2012 and remained there for 6 months. There's no question in my mind that Columbia Physician and Surgeons has a mandate to reveal the CAT scans, the MRI, and every test that they had done regarding Hillary Clinton's physical status.
Absolutely. So just release it all, and you don't have any excuses to do it, or you're hiding something clearly.
Correct. Now, let me go over this, Alex, and I appreciate it, and I want the audience to understand. As most of the audience realizes, I don't usually come on the show unless I have something that I'd like to tell the American audience, which is very, very important. One of the other issues in my world as a psychological operations and intelligence officer and as a DAS, I used to give lectures on presidential health at Fort McNair and West Point. And what I used to go over was how we in the Republic hide the health of our president. And I start with Woodrow Wilson, who had a stroke. And for a year and a half, he was in a comatose state where Colonel House and his wife was running the White House. We can't have that. Secondly, we had FDR, who was a cripple, and the Secret Service made certain that no one took pictures of Franklin Roosevelt as a cripple in the administrations he was in. Then we had a far more serious problem. When I was at Cornell Medical School between 64 and 68, a pathology class was given to us that really revealed the story of an individual who went into surgery at Cornell in orthopedic surgery and became psychotic. Who was that individual? It was John F. Kennedy. Subsequently, we found out that John F. Kennedy came into the White House illegally and in the Navy illegally, because he had a Addison's disease, ADDISONS, which meant that he had a deficiency and absence of the adrenal gland and had to be given daily shots of steroids, amphetamines, and vitamins from Dr. Feelgood. As a result of that, he became psychotic, inappropriate, and we ended up with the Cuban Missile Crisis because Khrushchev saw exactly what was happening, that we had a totally disoriented, incapable president, and eventually he had to go. Subsequently, we had a problem with Nixon, whom I had worked with, not directly. He had stress and had developed thrombophlebitis. He became paranoid as a result of Watergate, and he had to leave. We then had a president whom I worked under, I did not work directly for, who had Alzheimer's. Whether he had Alzheimer's towards the end of his administration or from the beginning is a very serious question. There's no question in my mind that during the Reagan administration, I had been working for James Baker as well as Bush Sr., who was then the vice president. Now we have a case where you have complete sociopathy. You have lies upon lies. There's no question her personality is one of a complete sociopath. Whatever they're saying about Trump right now, that he's sociopathic, he's not capable, he's impulsive, that's all nonsense coming from 50 totally incompetent Republicans whom I know personally and had worked with. Michael Hayden, who's director of the CIA and was the director of National Security Agency, was nothing more than a political general. In the military intelligence field, as one of my generals once said, he's a moron, and he was not considered the brightest of all. The only man I would respect among all of them was John Negroponte, who was a serious ambassador.
All right, so Dr. Pachinik, again, you have treated world leaders, treated U.S. leaders, that's all on record. So you are an expert of experts. You are sitting here, you know, certified to look at this neurology as an MD and as a psychiatrist on record, and the former head of psychological warfare of the State Department. So you're perfectly, you know, vetted, probably the best person in the world to talk to on this. I'm not a rocket scientist, but I can ask somebody, hey, do you have Parkinson's disease? Yes, I do. I mean, I can see when someone looks like they have a neurological disorder or Parkinson's type, you know, spectrum or whatever. Now, when I'm not a doctor. I have no training in it, but I've seen it enough to know what it is. You, as a truly educated expert, 6 months a few years ago, disappearing into this brain tumor specialist facility, all the bizarre behavior, her obviously degenerating, acting so angry, looking disoriented, having many seizures, looking at her, just in the videos you see online, if you saw that of a layperson, what would you say is wrong with them?
I would say that she has a occult brain tumor, either glioblastoma, or that she has possibly an onset of Alzheimer's disease, which begins as what we would call a subcortical vascular dementia because of thrombosis to the brain. Either way, it has to be ruled out. If she has early onset dementia, which she may well have, which came out in the issue with Chris Wallace and her quick discussion as a short circuit, and then Kane, her vice president, took over, it clearly said to me that Hillary at this point is not qualified physically, mentally, or emotionally to be the president of the United States unless she is given a clean record of health, which I doubt will happen. Now, let me give you exactly what happened. They produced a most cockamamie or a very run-down or watered-down medical history. This is public. Her primary care physician is Dr. Lisa Bardak. I don't know who she is. She's an internist, consistent with their position. She's the chairman of the Department of Medicine at Mount Kisco, New York. Now, you're talking about a very small town in comparison to where Hillary was really treated, which was physicians and surgeons at Columbia. And Columbia knows very well, the neurologists there know very well, that she was worked up with an MRI, CAT scans, and everything else.
Sure, so what they're doing is she's going to some local treating physician, doing a limited thing, not sharing the other medical records from years ago, and then putting that out as her supposed medical history.
Correct. Then she has anticoagulant treatment. Now, is she still on any coagulant? We have to know that. That means she's bleeding out. She had three episodes of concussion that she even documented, 98, 2009, and 2012, where she had to be treated for 12 months. She wore glasses that are called Fresnel prism glasses, which are usually worn by patients who have diplopia or double vision, and they have to be able to see better. And that was shown in the Benghazi inquiry.
Yes, sir. What are you seeing when you see her, what looks like as a layperson, a seizure where she seems to not have balance, and then she's been taught to smile and act like it's fun, but people say, are you okay?
Well, what you see there is the classical petite mal, which can go into a grand mal seizure. And then what I saw was the gentleman who came by her, the Secret Service, and gave her diazepam, which is Valium, in order to reduce the seizure activity.
And that's the key. They're running up, injecting her with what? I guess a depressant to stop the brain activity?
Yes, an anticonvulsant medication. She would be on Dilantin and other parts. But here's the issue. The issue I'm getting to is far greater than even Hillary Clinton. It's the problem that we have with the Secret Service, with the FBI and the CIA. And I come back to it again and again and again. I don't wish her illness. But I do condemn the Secret Service for the fact that their only loyalty is to their job and to the President of the United States. It is not to the Republic. They have covered up more malfeasance, more irregularity, and more miscreant behavior.
Dr. Pajenik, we'll get into that, and I'm glad that you're making this a compendium, not just about Hillary Clinton.
No,
that there's a history of this. Sure. There's a history of it. You know Hillary. You've not even really bashed her on this show. You haven't even said nice things about her. The larger issue, though, is she looks extremely ill, extremely out of it. It's one thing if the president's got a heart problem. It's one thing if they've even, you know, got a cancer that can be treated. But if she looks so angry, looks so crazed, or looks out of it, and is reportedly so mean and so rude to people now, I mean, to me, that just is what I've heard about Alzheimer's or dementia, and it shows she's degenerating very, very quickly. I'm just concerned about putting somebody like her in power, I mean, for the obvious reasons. So what do you think she's specifically done? Obviously, call for the release of her full medical records. What else?
Well, there's call for release of a full medical record. At the same time, I would want Congress to call in the Secret Service to demand exactly what they have witnessed, what they have seen under oath.
What are you injecting her with? There should be congressional hearings. Why does a person follow her with a tranquilizer dart?
They won't do that because it'll look partisan. But at the same time, I would put a gag order on everyone who's involved in any way in adding ad hominem comments I mean, the fact that 50 Republican ex-experts, all of whom were neocons, Zelik, though, you have Zelik.
No, I get it. You don't want political points. You care about the Republic.
I don't care about the political points. I care about the mental health and the medical health of this woman, and it has to be addressed ASAP.
Is she unfit to be the nominee?
At this point, yes. Unless proven otherwise.
Let me ask you this, because
she is not qualified to be the president of the United States as of today. She neither has the mental capacity, the physical capacity, as we've seen them bring her up.
I interrupt you, Dr. Pachinik. Start over with that statement, because we're going to put this out. Start over.
I demand that she have an independent medical neurological evaluation by people who are neither Republicans nor Democrats, to evaluate her mental status and physical status to be the president of the United States. I demand that Columbia PNS release the records on the neurological workup of a president of the United States, potential president. Columbia has a far greater obligation to the country than it does to its patients. The HIPAA law, which ironically was brought in by Bill Clinton, has to be broken, because it's a far greater issue than the concern of one individual. We are now talking about the nation state. What we've seen is a lot of distraction of a group of her people, including Republicans, who may or may not have been co-opted, to say that Trump is impulsive, he's erratic. In fact, the reality is that's a lot of distortion and distraction which belongs to her. And in time...
Well, I've actually found Trump is super disciplined and is just like a workhorse and very, very calm and focused in private. And that's what folks that know him
correct.
Say.
Correct. Well, I'm not here. I don't want to get into politics, but let's make it very clear. There is no history that I know about Trump where he has actually killed individuals intentionally or unintentionally. Her history.
Yeah, Trump hasn't gone around and destabilized all these countries and said,
correct.
I came, I saw, he died.
Correct. Now, we can honestly say her judgment about Libya is in question. Was it her judgment because she thought that was the best thing to do? Or did she have an underlying psychological, neurological problem which compelled her to act and be aggressive and go to war, as she did in Iraq and elsewhere?
Well, that was my next question, because you are a top psychiatrist. Let me expand on that. A lot of times you read about dementia, you read about brain tumors. People tend to start acting like kids. They tend to have rages. They tend to get aggressive. In a lot of videos, I thought it was just her acting like a kid for her audience, but more and more, I see her on C-SPAN and things off the side acting like a little kid, but also kind of raging and stomping around. What is that indicative of, Doctor?
It's indicative of onset of possibly dementia. A dementia, in her case, would not be unusual, because she's 69 years old, going on 70. With all due respect to her, she's been under a lot of stress. She's flown all over the world. She has been dehydrated, but she has a well-known history of having concussions, not just one concussion, but concussions in 1998, 2009, and a major concussion 2012, where she had to wear the Fresnel prisms, which means that she has an ongoing post-concussion syndrome and or a glioblastoma or an onset of dementia or all three. But without an independent evaluation, without the release of the records from Columbia, not from this Dr. Lewis Bardak. I don't know who she is.
No, I understand. Release the real medical records. Why was she disappeared for a year, 6 months in treatment? That's not blood clots.
No, that is far more serious than a blood clot. And also, usually when I examine the resident, I often ask, what does it mean when you have a history of multiple blood clots? Now, usually, most residents don't know that. The answer is that we have a hidden tumor. And in this case, it could well be glioblastoma, which is a very serious
And by tumor. Hidden, sir, can you give us the technicals? Do you mean it's a deep tumor?
Deep tumor, which is quite aggressive or can be controlled with chemotherapy, radiation, or some other.
Well, we have to speculate. I mean, she looks pretty bad. She disappears for large periods of time. She has to be to the bathroom longer during a debate.
Correct. If this were to occur in Trump right now, if Trump were to evidence the kind of behavior that she evidenced, with all due respect, we would immediately have asked for Trump's background in terms of medical history, psychiatric history, and all. It's also interesting that throughout her whole life, even as a senator, she keeps on confabulating a story where she created all kinds of economic opportunity. Yet today I wrote a whole blog saying that she didn't create any jobs in New York State. In fact, that 25% of the jobs went under through her 8 years of a tenureship, and then had to pay the Houghton family, who the Corning Glass, she paid them $330,000 for speeches, paid $220,000 to the eBay family, when she in fact accomplished nothing. So what she
Sure, well, let's expand on this. Well, what does the psychology say of her and Bill that they would steal the George Washington plates and cutlery?
Well, in that sense, you have what I've always said. You have basically a very low-class sociopathic family of folie à deux, which really is an arrangement of two people.
You're talking about white trash.
In effect, yeah, that's not a diagnosis, but Bill has never been honest. Bill has never accomplished really anything. Bill is born of a mother who was in the prostitute business. He came out of Hope, Arkansas, which was the headquarters of the mob for the Jews and the Italians. And, I mean, that history is well known. But to come forth and then bring us, again, another problem of sociopathy, we have to start to ask the question, what's the underlying mental...
Let's answer that straight ahead and talk about the Iran $400 million. Then we're going to shift gears into the mass murderer's father showing up at the Hillary rally. We are back live. Dr. Steve Pichenik, MD/psychiatrist, a board certifying individual who's run entire federal facilities, treated presidents, you name it. Went through a whole history earlier of how there's this long-term program of bipartisanly of covering up serious illnesses, a lot of times because vice presidents and others want to basically be running the show. That means George Soros, I guess, in the case of Hillary. But Hillary is falling down. She is suddenly doesn't know who she is in press conferences. She won't give press conferences. She spent off and on a year in a very secretive medical facility that deals with brain tumors. I wanted to play a brief clip before we shift gears to another subject with him, since he mentioned it, this Fox News clip from Hannity. What do Hillary Clinton's neurological records show? Not the ones she put out from her little family doctor, you know, in New York that are just limited, but the real ones, the CAT scans, her true records. Here's a clip.
The picture, which shows Hillary Clinton apparently needing assistance to climb a flight of stairs at a campaign stop back in February, was picked up by the Drudge Report, which posted this headline over the weekend, detailing Hillary Clinton's history with falls and speculating that the former Secretary of State could be experiencing a serious undisclosed medical condition. Earlier today, we reached out to the Clinton campaign for a statement, and a spokesman told us that the Drudge Report is shameful, and anyone who buys into that vitriol, including yours truly, is shameful as well. So shameful we are. Anyway, but what was noticeably missing from the statement was any reference or rebuttal to the health issues that are alleged by Drudge and others. And Jim Hoft in an article, and, you know, Hillary's handler, I guess, called with a diazepam pen. What would that be for?
So one of the things that happens after having concussion, usually within a year or so, you should all the symptoms should resolve. Occasionally, you have a latent or delayed kind of post-concussion syndromes, and seizure
so like
is one of those.
Like traumatic head issues for a football player.
Exactly what it is. And that can come years down the road. She may have some of these symptoms.
You think that's what you're seeing?
Well, I certainly think that a traumatic brain injury with symptoms down the road is very, very likely here, especially since she had a blood clot on her brain. And as David was mentioning, that can actually lead to a seizure problem. Someone's carrying a pen that you would use in the case of a seizure, a Valium pen. That makes me wonder about that. We need to see her records to see. Mm-hmm. What's the sequelae?
They want Donald Trump's tax. There's two things we want from her. We want her speeches to Wall Street and the medical records in full.
Well said. I mean, how is that shameful when she's falling down? She's obviously having seizures. She looks worse. She's got weird lesions, rot holes on her tongue in multiple shots. She either acts disoriented or like a crazy, I mean, I don't mean to be mean. I'm not a neurologist. I'm not a psychiatrist. I've seen Down syndrome children when they are either really bummed out, depressed, or they get these euphoric, crazy things where they look up and look like the Joker. She just acts like a crazy person. I mean, she acts like a crazy schizophrenic would, you know, at a four-way stop in downtown Austin. And she looks like a bag lady with her. I mean, I'm not being mean here, folks. I'm telling you, she looks like a classically insane person. Is that caused by a brain tumor? Is it caused by something else? I mean, everyone's just going with the story that, oh, she was in the hospital off and on for a year for a blood clot. Dr. Steve Pachinik, again, formerly a board certifying psychiatrist, MD, former head of psychological warfare for the State Department, you know, a guy that ran entire medical facilities. I mean, snapshot of this, dead reckoning. Is this a woman getting better from something or worse?
There's no question she's worse. Let me say something. She's not schizophrenic. Let me put the correct words. I know you're saying it in your lay terms. And remember, they're going to accuse us, you and me, of being conspiratorial since we've been doing this since 2001.
Sir, I totally understand. I'm saying I'm a layperson.
Alex, I'm not apologizing. All I'm saying to your audience is when we first said that 9/11 was a stand-down, everybody said we were crazy.
And now it's come out.
And that came, now we know it was true. In the same way, I'm saying, as I said 13, 14 years ago, Hillary Clinton, and I wish her no illness. I've known her before. I've met her. She's a good mother, and Bill Clinton was a good mother to Chelsea. I happen to know that. But the reality is, when you see her now, for whatever reason, as a physician, as somebody who is an official within the State Department and still helps our government for free and cares about our presidency, I have nothing against Hillary per se. I'm just simply stating that her history of sociopathy, her history of ongoing denial and distortion, particularly when Chris Wallace interviewed her and said, you're lying. Everything you said about Comey was the reverse, can manifest itself as confabulation, as an issue within herself of having a history of severe concussions, 3 to 4 times possibly. We know it's in 1998. We know it's in 2009. We know in 2012, Bill Clinton even stated clearly she was in the hospital for 6 months under the care of physicians and surgeons. Here is what has to be done. Physicians and surgeons must open their record, not because they're doctors and not because they're sanctimonious and not because of HIPAA laws. We have to open those records because the state of the nation and possibly the world depends on what her mental health is and her medical condition.
That's right. When you want to be the president of the United States, you then make yourself open to the public. Things that were private now must
correct.
Be public because you now represent us, and I certainly agree. So in closing, if you have to dead reckon, Dr. Pachinik, I want to spend a few minutes on another issue and then let you go. I know you're busy.
No, let me say the second part. There's no question the Secret Service has to be brought before Congress to assess under oath what they have done and what they have seen. Not one of these things where they remain there for 10 years and then they write their books. That's not going to be acceptable. The Secret Service will be indicted for collusion in terms of creating a problem for the United States of America. Their loyalty is to the people of the United States, not to the presidency. Either they're funded by us and they respond to our request, or we defund them. There is no question the Secret Service for 50 to 60 years has covered up major malfeasance and malpractice that occurred in
the White House. Well, look, they want to expose Hillary and others.
It's the same thing. They covered up for John F. Kennedy. They covered up for Reagan. They covered up for a whole group of people. If that's, in fact, what they do, then they are in collusion with malfeasance.
No, I hear you. But bottom line, we need to get these documents out. And
correct.
I mean, I think it's becoming a major issue, and clearly Trump is dead even or ahead in the real polls. They're putting out fake polls. As a former top psychological warfare expert, a guy that's helped keep governments in power, overthrow foreign governments, people that don't know who you are, you're a rock star of that, probably more than anybody living. Dr. Steve Pachinik, looking at this election, just as a media analyst, I've never seen them photoshopping things, delisting Google, dirty tricks against Donald Trump. A, do you agree with that statement? And B, why are they pulling out all the stops?
Because they're frightened, and also this is the modus operandi of the Clinton machinery. They have always been crooked. When Clinton came in the first time around, and I worked for Bush Sr., I said to one of my CIA operatives, what in fact happened? How did this guy from Arkansas, who nobody knew, we knew in the State Department that he was receiving money from mainland China. That was in 88, 89. And my CIA operative told me he's been on the payroll of the Chinese and they stole the election. Remember the old Stalin statement. It's not how many people vote or who votes. It's the person who counts the votes. And whether they have doctored the machinery, whether they haven't doctored it, they are completely complicit in malfeasant activities.
Sure, well,
they
Doc, know it. Let me tell you this. I can't go see a movie like The Martian.
No, it's a waste of time.
I can't go see the new Star Trek movie, none of them. Every major action movie or sci-fi movie is how great the communist Chinese are, with Politburos, red flags. The Starlet Girl is a communist Chinese colonel. We get our rocket boosters in The Martian from the communist Chinese to save our mission because we're idiots. I mean, it's like Hollywood has become, because that's how you know who you're working for. I mean, Hollywood now, when I see almost any movie, there is red Chinese propaganda in it. And this just started happening 2 years ago. And let me tell you, it is freaking me out.
Well, I wouldn't worry about Hollywood. Having been a producer and I'm part of the Producers Guild, Hollywood is finished. They have no more capability to develop films than the past.
No, I agree with you, but since when did the red Chinese start running it?
Well, that's not the issue as much as the fact that nobody's going to movies, and the millennials are now streaming all of the content. So let's not worry about Hollywood. What we have to worry about now is the fact that now, and let's get into the 400 million, I had the four horsemen of the apocalypse, Obama, Comey, Brennan, three horsemen, go in and Kerry and give a ransom of $400 million, part of a $1.7 billion ransom for four Americans held in Iran. You know how criminal that is? That's treason. If I had done that over the past 30 to 40 years as the head of counterterrorism and international hostage negotiation, I would have been in prison for that. And believe me, the FBI would be more than happy to hand me subpoenas. But when the head of the FBI, the head of the CIA, the president of the United States, and John Kerry pay ransom money, basically to keep the Iranians quiet, of $1.7 billion.
Isn't it like Rudyard Kipling said in that poem that once you pay the pirate, you must do it over and over again?
Correct. You never stop. And the Iranians have continuously, they took two more hostages after that. And so once again, they're going through this action of paying off hostages.
But everybody knows you don't pay off people. Why do they do it?
Because they're cowardly and because they're inept. And I can't tell you how inept they really are. Comey has failed repeatedly. He failed to indict Hillary. He failed to really handle the FBI.
What did you make of that, speaking of schizophrenic speech where he indicts her, she's horrible, she's lied, she's evil, but then no one will go after her? I mean, what did you make of his speech?
Well, the point of the speech was that he made a very serious mistake when he had General Petraeus, who had given over eight notebooks to his mistress and had committed a crime that was a felony. And then Petraeus, on top of that, lied. So what did Comey and at that time Eric Holder do? They made him a misdemeanor. As a result of that, he said that no efficient prosecutor can indict her. What he meant was that he messed up. Once again, Comey has to resign because he messed up not only once under Petraeus, he messed up again under Hillary Clinton. And you can't have an FBI that could not indict a woman like that because of the issue that they had already messed up under Petraeus. So what we have is compounding mistakes again and again. And an
All right, I hear you. Well, Dr. Steve Pachinik, simply amazing info. Anytime you want to come on, just call Nico. We'd love to get you on.
Thank you for the opportunity, and God bless your audience.
Let me just say one more thing. You offered a couple years ago to fly to Austin and to be in studio. I know your face hadn't been seen in forever. We could do like Drudge and have you over there in the corner blacked out. But I want to get you a plane ticket here in the next month or so if you want to do it. come to Austin and check out the facility. At, you know, after us talking on air for 15 years, it's 15 now, Doc, almost 15.
And we've had a good friendship. Let's keep it that way. Otherwise, you don't want to see my face.
Okay, well, before you said you wanted to come to Austin, remember that?
Well, yeah, a long time ago, but now I'm happy just being in the rural South and working with my people. But the truth of the matter is, let's get the medical records out, and the doctors on Fox News were absolutely correct. They're both excellent doctors. One works at Mount Sinai. The other one's a famous internist. And like them, I said, let's get the medical records and find out what this is all about. And I thank you, Alex, for the opportunity to talk.
Thank you. Just in closing, in 60 seconds, I think even if the establishment steals this election, which they're trying to set up right now with fake polls, that it's the end, though. I mean, they're really showing their cards. They've got a obviously collapsing, degenerating, it's very sad, rotting woman who they're foisting like a dead king, you know, up in his chair. And, you know, the El Cid trick worked for about 30 seconds, you know, where he rides out against the Moors. But in the real world, you can't have a corpse in the White House for too long, especially in the age of the Internet. And if the Secret Service and others think they can cover this up for a long time, I think they're wrong. What do you think all this craziness signifies, Dr. Steve Pachinik of stevepachinik.com?
Well, we're on the process of a republic which has been led over 30 years by incompetent presidents of the United States who were not qualified, including Obama. I said it from the very beginning. He was a liar. He was a sociopath. He would lie all the way through the White House and couldn't care less. The same thing with Bush Jr., the same thing with Bill Clinton. The only thing, I'm not here to promote Trump, although I favor Trump for one simple reason. He's had a business experience. He's going to clean out whatever there is. As to what his personality is, I could care less.
But well, wait, you're a board-certifying psychiatrist from Harvard and a former head of counterterrorism and a commando before that. So I think you're certified to tell us what you really think of Trump. What do you think of his psychology? Because I read these big psychology things in Atlantic
Trump
Monthly.
Like all of us, we're a bit narcissistic, but I think Trump has been able to advance despite the problems ahead of him. And he was courageous enough to go forth and said, look, I want to be president of the United States. He's the first businessman we've ever
had. He's not out to get America. Do you agree with my analysis that he's not out to get us?
No, he wants, if anything, I think he wants, and he picked a very good man in Michael Pence. He wants to get forth and clean out the entire establishment that's totally corrupt, including the Clintons, the Republicans, the FBI, the CIA, the DNI. I mean, Michael Hayden, and then he wants to get in, clean it out, and he would be more than happy to give it over to Pence and to the people that he brings into the government.
Well, you just showed the inside baseball. Truth is, Trump doesn't want to do any of this. He just wants to fix it and get out and go play golf.
That's exactly right.
You know the inside baseball, don't you? Because that's
right.
The truth. Trump doesn't even want to be president. He just can't sit there and watch this happen.
He's doing it simply because it's a mandate that he felt he needed to do and just clean it out. But he's correct. He read Hillary correctly. He read the problems correctly. He stated that we have a rigged election. Bernie unfortunately left and was overwhelmed and couldn't continue.
Well, they're pretty freaked out because they know, and it's not a secret. So, I mean, Trump's a listener, been a listener for a long time, and they're really upset about it. Dr. Pachinik, thank you. StevePachinik.com, all your great books and material. Let's get you up for a hour soon about the great book about your mom, just from a historical perspective.
Thank you, Alex.
There he goes. Joe Biggs has got, thank you, big news on this mass murder at the gay nightclub showing up at the Hillary rally. I don't get up here and attack Hillary as a dirty trick to say she's obviously completely ill. I mean, you can look at her. She looks like she's in bad shape. But for me, it's the bigger issue that her and Bill have been communist Chinese spies forever. You just heard it from Dr. Steve Pachinik, who was the former head of counterterrorism for the United States, for the U.S. Army and more. And the entire structure that isn't traitors knows that this country is in so much trouble. I mean, it really is crazy. And now we've got this exercise of Hillary going and blaming the Second Amendment for what happened in Orlando. And there in the crowd, you've got the father, Sadiq Matin, of Omar Matin, who killed 50-plus people. And then he goes on the news and is arrogant and proud of it. And then Hillary spins it and says, oh, he wasn't invited when they were in the vetted group. Joe Biggs has covered many Hillary rallies. He's got the documentation, Joe Biggs.
Yeah, so I want to go back to the mental state of Hillary Clinton really quick, if we can. My grandmother died of Alzheimer's. My great-grandmother died of Alzheimer's. And all started with falling down, forgetting who people were, twitching, things like that. So it definitely looks like she almost has an onset of Alzheimer's in a sense. Like there's definitely something going on.
That's what Pachinik said, plus brain tumor.
I mean, that's definitely a possibility. Now, with what happened in Orlando, she actually spoke at a rally in Kissimmee. I actually retweeted some video just a minute ago from this girl who was in Kissimmee at the rally. She's a Trump supporter. And what they actually did is they fudged the numbers. This is a room, a building that held about 3,000 people. They actually moved the walls in and tightened it up so it looked like there was a ton of people in there for when they filmed. And then in the back area was completely wide open.
Yeah, so the footage is up on your Rambo Biggs. It's also on our article that's on drudgereport.com, Infowars.com, breaking that down. It's crazy.
But she can't even, in Omaha, she can't even fill up a rally. They had to bring in high school kids to fill it up. You know, there's multiple areas where no one's coming out, but they want to tell you that she's leading in the polls and more people are for her. When in fact, when you go to Trump rallies, there are thousands upon thousands of people and people mile long wrapped around the buildings to go hear this man speak. But no one is for her.
How do they think they're going to pull this off? I mean, they admit they're adding 15% more Democrats to poll samples to give her a lead. It's pure bull. How dumb do they think we are?
What is it? Pennsylvania, 60,000 people switched over from Democrat to Republican. To
it's a landslide and they're going to try to steal it. And I tell you, they got the new Fox News director for Ailes. He was on this morning and oh, it's true. Hillary's going to win by 12 points. He's this real Nelly guy. And don't listen to others, these unhealthy polls. They are really... They had to take Fox down, though, so that they couldn't challenge it.
Well, yeah, if you start watching Fox now, you start seeing they're starting to lean more towards Clinton. Every time you hear these guys, except for Sean Hannity, like it's all like, oh, Clinton's not so bad.
Well, I'm not going to get Hannity in trouble, but he did reach out to us. He said, great job. We appreciate you. I'm trying my best. They're threatening to fire him right now. So he reached out to us and said he appreciates us. But yeah. This country's in deep crap, brother. They are cooling Fox News.
But
they got fake polls out. They got Fox this morning on 3 different shows I watched going, oh, he's always been behind Hillary. He's going to lose by 12 points, yeah.
But it's a top story. They go, well, David Duke endorsed Trump. And then he goes, well, I disavowed him. They're like, well, are you going to disavow him? He's like, well, I just did it. How many times do I have to do it? And then she brings out Khan to the DNC to speak. This guy says that Sharia law should be held over all other laws.
He's just like Sadiq Matin.
Yeah, and now you have Sadiq Mateen, the father of Omar Mateen, the Orlando Pulse nightclub killer. And they're saying, well, we didn't invite him. He wasn't asked to be here. Well, I've been to tons of these rallies before. When I'm able to come in as press, that row behind where the presidential candidate speaks is already full before they let in the main public who have been waiting, who have tickets.
That's admitted. It's always vetted, trusted Democrat turds.
Yeah, now, if he was in the regular crowd standing up, then I could understand. You know, maybe he got one of those regular emails and decided to show up. But he was standing behind a presidential frontrunner for the Democratic Party, right there, smiling, waving, all happy and excited. This is who's in her corner.
So what's the message? They're obviously doing this on purpose.
This is like a message to people out there. Hey, bring anybody in. I want to talk about a statement when we get back that he made that I think is very important.
Yeah, stay with us. Infowars.com/show. Stations across the country. Spread the word. Don't take this transmission for granted, folks. Communications Radio Network. And they are pulling the stops out. Folks, if Trump was really behind in polls, I'd tell you, if any of their BS was real, I'd say the public's pathetic. They're idiots like I did 10 years ago. What's wrong with you people? They're not. Trump gets 20,000. Sanders gets 20,000. Hillary gets 179. We can't find people at exit polls for Hillary in the primaries. They stole it. Joe Biggs is here with us.
When I was in Long Beach, California, a bulk of the people that were waiting in line to go into Long Beach, that community college, to hear Clinton speak, were Trump supporters or Bernie supporters who just wanted to go hear her lie in person to see if it's really as bad as what they've seen in videos.
Man does not look into the Gorgon and live.
I mean, most people aren't going out here because they really believe in what she's saying. They're doing it for the circus, the show, to be like, all right, man, I hear her lie, but I want to see in person.
Exactly. And then on those days, she gets 1,000. So what does this mean that they admit in different polls they're running every scam you can imagine, or they'll do a third independence. They don't just randomly call numbers. Who has landlines? Plus, they know who they're calling before they call. They'll have a third independence, a third Democrat, a third Republican. They'll poll them, but then all the independents are basically Democrats already. Or they admit they sample 15% more Democrats. I mean, it's admitted fraud. And the whole media just goes along like it's okay, Joe.
Oh, it's complete and total fraud because I go to all these events. I can hardly find a Hillary Clinton supporter. At the DNC, for instance, The only Clinton supporters were inside, really. Meanwhile, they're not even talking about the massive amount of chaos going on. The Sanders supporters that are upset about having the nomination stolen.
If you wear a Hillary shirt, they attack you.
Oh, they did. They did that to people. It's out of control. People do not like her. People have
What do you think her real numbers are? I think it's like 10%.
It's a big psyop. You know, most people are going to watch the TV. They're going to look at it. They're going to believe it and take it as, you know, the Ten Commandments. They're going to say, all right, well, Fox News said that this poll is this, or CNN or Rachel Maddow came out and said that this is the poll number. It's a psyop to make the regular person, the sheep, the I'm with herd, to come out there and go.
Do you know how pissed they are that Trump listens to the show? I mean, it's not about me. It's dangerous. I'm not even, but they are so freaked out. When I ran into globalists at the RNC, they were just totally freaked.
I mean, people are waking up. People are sick and tired of hearing this crap. You know, there's a lot of people I run into at all these events, and they go around, they save up, and they go to these events to talk to people and engage, and no one can find Hillary supporters. When you go to them,
we should do special reports like In Search of Hillary Supporters. We can find a few at UT,
yeah,
a few in the rich neighborhoods. That's another thing. They're always so rich.
Well, if you look at most of her rallies up until now, they've been private. She does them at
rich people houses.
They do them at these billionaire houses. You have to spend like $20,000.
And they shake their finger at us when there's a bunch of blue-collar folks who just want a better job saying we're elitist.
Yeah, $7,000 to be able to be given the address to the place. Then $15 or $15,000 to sit down at the table beside her or in the vicinity to be around Her Highness. And then $20,000 to ask her a question privately or something like
that. A woman wearing a diaper.
Yeah, she looks like
Mal. Nothing against diapers, but I mean, you know. I'm not normally for burkas, but I think she needs one.
I wouldn't mind.
Have you seen the new thing with the Teletubby outfits the Muslim women are wearing at the Olympics?
The beekeeper outfits.
No, but those are beekeepers. These are like Teletubby outfits.
Yeah, I saw that. The volleyball players.
Yeah. I mean,
what the fuck? Oh, my God.
Look, I get it if you want to wear conservative clothes and do all that. That's what I like in my family. I tell my daughters, hey, don't dress like you're trying to get a job, you know, at the local strip club. But at the same time, like, it's volleyball. Like, let the women be in bathing suits, you know?
Yeah. And it was an interesting thing if we go back to this Kissimmee thing where...
We will. We got another guest coming on. Mr. Ryan Shotgun with us.
Okay, cool.
Thanks for the rest of the hour. And then David Knight's taking over and a lot more. Listen, here's the deal. I got to laugh and make jokes about this or I'm going to slit my wrists. And I'm serious. I'm not going to actually commit suicide. They'll kill me. It's a figure of speech. The point is that I don't think this is funny, but I have to make it funny or I can't handle it.
Exactly.
Because it's just hilarious. We'll be back. We have a guest joining us who is at the border. I believe it's Lithuania going into Russia. There's a big convoy of Germans going into Russia in an attempt to draw attention to NATO and Merkel and the globalists moving tanks, weapons, and nukes up to the border of Russia, trying to start a new Cold War. We've got top mainline analysts here in the U.S. admitting that all of this is actually going on and unfolding as well. We should probably play that clip from one of the top Princeton professors from CNN from last week, where he illustrates the fact that they're saying Donald Trump is, you know, this communist agent. Russia's not even communist anymore because he doesn't want to have a war and wants to have detente. But Hillary does because she's so liberal, she's so cool. And Joe Biggs is obviously going to ride shotgun with us the rest of the hour. After our guests leave us at the bottom of the hour, we're going to burrow in to the father, Sadiq Mateen, of Omar Mateen, the gay nightclub pulse killer of more than 50 people, who shows up in the VIP area of the Hillary event, gets behind her on the stage, and then is on the local news. Joe is burrowing into this, researching this right now. Also at the same event and at other events, they make the crowd look much larger. 1,000 showed up to see Hillary. It's 179, according to the Secret Service. But she's the rock star that's going to win the election. Now, Max Bachmann is an independent journalist. He's had a TV program on national German television. And, of course, he's also done reporting for Infowars.com for Bilderberg 2015-2016 at generalist.org, Twitter, the_generalist. And he joins us to tell us about this convoy that I guess means friendship, the peace drive from Berlin to Moscow is a citizens' initiative to promote international friendship between Germany and Russia. the Germans and Russians killed about 20 million on each side in World War II, 40 million plus dead. Yeah, it's good I didn't have another war. And they are involved in a convoy to draw attention to what's happening. The website is drushba.info. We'll get into the meaning of that word. Max, thanks for joining us. And again, he is on the border there. We tried this yesterday. I think it might be three times the charm.
Thanks for having me.
Let him go through the checkpoint, and then we'll get him on later. Twice is the try, but we've plugged it. We've done it. I'll try it one more time tomorrow, and then we'll maybe cover some of their HD videos once they put them out. See, he did a great job reporting from Bilderberg for us, but we're having internet issues. We're going to shut that down right now. It's the magic of Skype, but I tell you, out in the middle of nowhere, it just doesn't work too well. Would be nice if other folks from Europe joined the convoy. It's why we're doing it, to tell you about it today. So there it is. Joe Biggs, shifting gears now. Let's look at this father, the surrealness. Drudge Report called it the Twilight Zone. This Sadiq Mateen, father of Omar Mateen, from the nightclub shooting, showing up. He has his own shows where he pushes the same garbage. It's all being protected. His dad's brought him by the CIA. What is going on?
Yeah, this guy is involved in a very large pro-Taliban movement. He spits out a lot of anti-homosexual rhetoric and stuff like that, where he calls for the cleansing of these kind of people. And meanwhile, you have a presidential candidate in Hillary Clinton who gets on stage and says she's for the LGBT. And she is taking money from Saudi Arabia. She's taking money from countries that murder them, throw them off buildings. And now you have this guy, the father of Omar Mateen, who killed over 49 people in Orlando, Florida, at the Pulse nightclub. And this guy is in the vetted area standing behind her. That should piss off a lot of people. And it also sends a message to other people out there. Hey, you want to go out and shoot some people up? Come on into the Democratic Party. Now, the local WPTV news actually stopped and talked to Sadiq and said, asked him a few questions. He said, I've been cooperating with the federal government, and that's about it. Thank you. And then he walked.
By the way, the footage of him behind Hillary is priceless from the newscast. For TV viewers, we can roll some of that behind to just see him smiling behind her. This does smell like PSYOP. What do you think's going on?
Yeah, definitely. He says, Hillary Clinton is good for the U.S. versus Donald Trump, who has no solutions. Now, the news crew ran into her a few miles down the road and was actually able to stop and interview him. So I don't know what happened in between the time that he didn't want to really give a statement into the, you know, miles down the road when this crew ran into him again, you know, accidentally at this rest stop. He then comes out and makes a statement that I think is very interesting. He says, it's the Democratic Party anyone can join. That's a statement he's making. He's looking at all those people. Hey, you want to come out here? You want to come out here? Because my son did this. My son carried out my wishes. You guys want to come out here? Guess what? The Democratic Party is going to be one that's going to allow you to come into this country. And the Democratic Party is allowing these borders to be wide open.
That's the message worldwide. He's conducting a jihad.
Yes. He's saying to all those people out there, those pro-Taliban supporters, those ISIS sympathizers, hey, man, you want to come to America? Come in, vote Democrat. Let's get Hillary Clinton in. We'll be able to have fun. And then they also want to push this whole gun control thing. Why would they want to push gun control? Why? Because gun-free zones are kill zones. They take the guns away, then they're psychotic, jihadi.
We have a literal, just like Khan pushes this Muslim law firm, Muslim journal, to turn us over to Sharia law, and the weird leftist cover for it all.
Yeah, exactly. He's able to sit here and go, what? Let's bring these people in. It's okay. Let's do this. But then when it comes out and say, oh, you want to make fun of Gold Star families or whatever like that. If you notice, the wife didn't say anything. Maybe it's because they're actually practicing Sharia law at home. Maybe Mr. Khan doesn't allow his wife to speak in public unless he speaks to him.
And by the way, we have a clip where Saudi Arabia on record is Hillary's biggest donor. Here it is.
What is the connection between Hillary Clinton and Saudi Arabia that suddenly got Israel angry?
Well, it's extensive. I mean, the relationships between Hillary Clinton and Saudi Arabia, between the Clinton Foundation and Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is probably the largest single donor to the Clinton Foundation. You can see Clinton's arms export policies, why she was Secretary of State, favoring extensively Saudi Arabia.
Yeah, I mean, she's a communist Chinese agent / Saudi Arabia agent. And folks, I criticize Israel when they're doing stuff that's wrong because, you know, Israel's a complex government. It's got bad people as well. But this thing that Israel makes the weather the way it is, and if you fall on a banana peel, Israel did it. No, I look at what who really runs it. And man, I'll say this, the Israel lobby has really rolled over to communist China. So, you know, bad on them for that. But Saudi Arabia, it is China. They've got so much money, they are just pumping it in. They are doing whatever they want. And I'm wondering, Joe Biggs, what is the bigger picture here? Why are they doing this? Where are they wanting to go?
I mean, the reason they can get away with it is because most people are scared to even go up against the Clintons. Think about since the DNC, Clinton body count or left-wing conspiracy, three with ties to DNC.
That's right, three top DNC people over the delegates dead, and they're all being found shot in the head.
Since the DNC committee emails were leaked a few weeks ago, three people associated with the DNC have all been found dead under what could be questionable circumstances, some including Bernie Sanders supporters suspect the Clintons were behind the deaths. Now, I know people... many of us that were out there, the DNC actually talked to these Sanders supporters, and they think that the reason that Sanders stood down is because he was threatened.
Well, no kidding.
You look at FBI Director James Comey coming out and all of a sudden listing out all these reasons why should she be indicted, why should she be thrown in jail, and then goes, well, no one's going to take that case, you know. And then you have this guy right here, Seth Rich, DNC staffer. Seth Rich was mysteriously murdered in the streets of Washington, D.C. on July 10th. Although it was being investigated as a robbery, his wallet, credit cards, and watch were not taken. The 20-year-old was walking back home from his girlfriend's apartment and was found shot in the back.
Well, we had the head of the DNC's outreach program, who was over delegates being found dead. He'd spoken out for Sanders, but...
Well, this guy, they believe, is the guy who actually leaked the 20,000 emails to WikiLeaks.
Ah.
They think that this guy, he was an intel analyst, a data analyst, and he was the one responsible. Because if you actually go back and look at the video with Julian Assange, he says that he did not get it from any kind of Russian hackers. Did not come from
them. Well, sure, the Russians have hacked some stuff, but they blame them for everything. What about conscientious people inside the system that see the corruption? And Assange has talked about the next group of emails will get Hillary indicted. Why isn't he releasing them quicker? Even James Woods has said, what's the line on Vegas for the chances of Julian Assange living until November 8th?
It's not going to look very good. You know, if this comes out and it's actually as bad as he's saying or as bad as he's building it up, there's something definitely going to happen. And he's been holed up in that Ecuadorian embassy for how long now? I mean, it's been years now. He's been there.
Exactly. We have a mysterious DNC desk clip. Let's play that.
And another man connected to the DNC has been found dead less than a month after the murder of DNC staffer Seth Conrad Rich. One America's Rachel Roboto tells us more about the mysterious death surrounding Sean Lucas and his involvement with the party's email scandal.
It was a celebratory day for Sean Lucas when he entered the DNC building last month and told a committee official, "You've been served." Lucas worked as a process server for the class action DNC lawsuit. The lawsuit was filed against both the committee and former DNC chairwoman Debbie Wasserman Schultz for allegedly committing acts of fraud after leaked emails revealed the DNC showed favoritism towards Hillary Clinton over Bernie Sanders. After serving the papers, Lucas told an independent filmmaker who captured the whole thing on video that although Schultz refused to meet with him, democracy was served.
Yeah, they wouldn't give us any of the head honchos, which I kind of had a feeling wasn't going to happen. But we did make contact with somebody from the Democratic National Committee's office, and they've been served. Democracy has prevailed today.
But in a bizarre twist of events, on August 2nd, less than 1 month after serving the subpoena, Lucas was reported dead. According to police records, Lucas's girlfriend found him lying on the floor unresponsive when she returned home that evening and immediately called 911. Paramedics said there was no sign of life by the time they arrived
on the
scene. Police are not releasing the cause of death at this time and are not commenting on speculation that Lucas was murdered. His unusual and sudden death is fueling speculation about the recent death of Seth Conrad Rich. Rich, a DNC employee, was working on several committee cases involving voter and election fraud before he was murdered by gunshots. He was also set to testify in the FBI's email investigation of Hillary Clinton before he was killed. Authorities have ruled his death as a robbery gone wrong, but police records indicate nothing was stolen from Rich, even though he had a cell phone, cash, and a watch on him at the time of the incident. No suspects have been arrested, and police are now offering a reward to anyone who knows more information.
And now there's been another death. That's One American News doing a great job. Joe Biggs?
There's another guy, John Ash, the former president of the United Nations General Assembly. This is a guy that was found that had died and had a barbell dropped on his head. But the interesting thing about it, the UN actually released a statement saying that he had died from a heart attack. And then it came out that they had found him with this barbell dropped on his head. He was a 61-year-old man. He was about to testify against Chinese real estate developer NG Lap Sing, who was implicated in the ChinaGate scandal for funneling money.
The Chinese funding Hillary again. Oh, he's dead. Oh. Yeah.
So, I mean, there's the Clinton body count. And actually, Darren McBreen, I know he's working on a report for tomorrow. He's doing a big thing on the body count. It's building up. And it's getting to a point where you're starting to see
now, people there's are never scared. Been dead bodies around the Clintons.
Yeah. I mean, have you heard about this? Two of the family members of the two of the guys that died in Benghazi have now sued Hillary Clinton for that.
Let's talk about that in a moment. I'm going to stop right now because I didn't even plug last hour. We're not going to be here if I don't stop not airing the ads. I'm skipping one right now. I can't even help it. So it's kind of like a schizophrenic deal where I just don't even want to have advertising. I don't want to mess with it, but I got to have it. And so we go out, we get the very best products we can at the very lowest prices, things that everybody needs, like water filtration systems, non-GMO seeds, incredible supplements, books, films, Hillary for prison shirts, Bill Clinton rape shirts. You want to be aggressive and get in these criminals' faces, you know, we're doing it. We have Anthroplex that is a male and female, but it's advertised to males. Enhancer for stamina, libido, energy, you name it. It's got 5-star reviews by thousands of folks. It's like Supermel Vitality. It has some different ingredients, but some of the same. Supermel is even stronger, but this is less. But the two go together well. It's kind of a base for that. It's 40% off. We've never done that. A lot of big specials just ended. This is our new special. 40% off Anthroplex at InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com. Again, is the big umbrella site. InfoWarsLife.com takes you right to the subpages. We also have 20% off the InfoWars Premium Power Pack that we sell even lower than major chains that sell it. It's a third the size of a briefcase, has all these different plugs in it for different adapters for your iPhone, your Droid, whatever, and will jump a car up to 12 times off of a single charge. And just the case is a third the size of a briefcase. The actual block is just, talk about miniaturization. This is the best cutting-edge system out there at the lowest price you're going to find even normally, 20% off. It is an absolute steal. InfoWarsStore.com. And we also have the solar panel control system and the solar panel system itself. That is 33% off. We've never offered that. We have these units in stock. This is the very best unit, highest rated, best quality, lowest price that we could find in this class. And at 33% off, it is a loss leader. The InfoWars Solar Base Station Power Supply, 33% off at InfoWarsStore.com. From our research, InfoWars Solar Base Station Power Supply is the most affordable and high-powered solar generator out there. And now we're giving you 33% off on the Solar Base Station at InfoWarsStore.com to help you get prepared while supplies last. InfoWars Solar Base Station uses a unique lithium-ion phosphate battery and will last up to 8 times longer than your typical unit. One unit provides 1,500 watts of continuous power or 3,000 watts of peak power for any emergency. The solar power supply is the real deal, and we're giving it to you for the lowest price possible. We've done the research, and this is the best emergency power backup out there. Get a bunch of these, run your whole house, great for camping, you name it. Get the InfoWars Solar Base Station at the lowest price ever at 33% off at InfoWarsStore.com today. And there's always free shipping on orders, $50 or more. You can always get 10% off when you sign up, even on top of other discounts for auto ship on any item that makes sense, to, like Anthroplex or colloidal silver, to get an additional 10% off that you want to get via auto ship. A Hillary for prison shirt, you name it. Your action is what's built InfoWars. You are InfoWars, and we're not here like the IRS taking money from you at gunpoint and giving it to MSNBC in a bailout or a stimulus package or $450 million a year to NPR. We're here just saying we got great products at really great prices, and we're crazy enough to go head up against Hillary and the globalists and the communist Chinese and the Saudi Arabians. But look, don't thank me if they do something to us. I'm not bending over to these people. I'm never joining them. I'm not scum. Okay, I don't support killing Buddhists and putting them in mobile execution vans and harvesting their organs. So people think it's heroic to fight this. It's insane not to. Joe Biggs, let's get more into this weirdo shooter father from the gay nightclub, the Pulse Club in Orlando, showing up at the stage Hillary event. He's there in the VIP area. He gives a press interview. This is unreal. What do you think's behind this?
I mean, he is definitely sending out a message, and they're allowing him to send out this message that, hey, if you want to come here, you vote Democrat, you can come here. Borders are going to be wide open. And then you have these guys pushing this gun control narrative where they want to have less guns. Look at California. Look at Chicago. Look at Chicago, where there's so many people.
You're saying the jihad's on. We're going to come here. We're going to kill people. My son's going to kill people. And then we're going to take the slaves' guns. We're going to take the demis' guns.
Exactly. I mean, if people need to wake up and see, this is scary. It's getting to a point. Now, look at this. Monday, Sadiq posted a video. Sadiq Mateen says his son was well-educated and respectful to his parents and that he was not aware what motivated him. Meanwhile, Sadiq has put out many videos saying that homosexuality is bad and these people should be killed. He then adds, God will punish
his dad
those.
Was saying the exact same crap his loon's son was doing.
Yeah.
You said it. It's just like in movies where they say they're sending out codes or whatever. It's not even coded. He's there saying, I'm here behind Hillary. I'm accepted. Come here, do this. We will take their guns. My dad sent me a text message earlier saying, hey, go look at demi contracts from over 11 Islamic countries where Christians and others have to sign a contract to pay 50% tax, not 10%, be slaves. Excuse me, I'm sorry, really bad allergies right now. Teleprompter free, folks. I'm not like Hillary, but I am sneezing. And I'm like, Dad, you print me the demi contracts, but you fought this. Bracken talks about this. Explain what a demi contract is.
Well, look at this, though. With Bo Bergdahl, what do we do with Bo Bergdahl? We release the Taliban 5, which means we are negotiating with terrorists. Now we have this money that we have given to Iran. We're sending out a message in so many ways. It's all right for you to come here. It's all right for you to jihad here. And if you get caught or if something happens, hey, it's going to be all right. We're going to trade our people up for you guys to come here and be comfortable. That's the big issue, is we're all about making these people feel comfortable here. Meanwhile, we can't even live in our own country peacefully. We can't be here happy. We can't even have our own culture. There's people within America, women who can go out and walk around wearing their clothing and be spit on and mocked at by these Muslim men who don't like the way they do it. But meanwhile, if we go to another country and don't abide by their culture, their rules, we're going to be looked down upon. But we're told that they can come here and do whatever they want. It's all going to be free. Meanwhile, there's veterans who are homeless, who are dying, who aren't getting the health care they need. But we're going to bring all these illegals over and allow them to have whatever they want, give them a court date 4 years down the road, never see them again.
Look, we're run by foreign enemies. There's no doubt. DrudgeReport.com is top linked our story. When will Hillary disavow Omar Mateen's father, man
exactly.
who supports Taliban and extermination of gays, shows up at Clinton rally. And I would just add, Paul, and it's put in VIP section.
Yeah.
He's put in VIP section.
When you go to these events, when you get your press pass, your credentials, when you walk into that facility, you will already see those bleachers behind that candidate that will come up and speak already full. And then the other people will start to funnel in on the outskirts, and that'll be your rally. Those people are already pre-picked, predetermined. They're usually local Democrats, people who give money to the Hillary Foundation or Bernie or whoever that's going to be speaking there. Those people are given the right to bring them plus two or three other people to come in and sit there. And this guy sitting here saying, oh, I just got an email and the Clinton campaign coming out. We didn't invite him. It's complete and total BS.
And listen, they stuck him there. They tell you where to stand at those.
Oh, yeah.
They stuck him there on purpose. So what is the PSYOP? Is it Hillary just literally rubbing it in? Just, we'll do whatever we want?
I mean, she wears these Mao uniforms, and then now she's sitting here.
Yeah, she wears Mao outfits.
And now she has Khan coming up and speaking, a guy who wants Sharia law over our law.
He founded a law group to enforce it in America.
Yes. And then we have people like Fethullah Gulen that we allow to come in. The CIA gives a backdoor key to come in.
He's got $150
billion. I mean, this is what our country's doing. They're telling these people, hey, Sharia law, that's fine. Patriotism, Second Amendment, First Amendment, that's bad. We don't want that here.
I can't believe it anymore. Stay there. We're going to be right back and take some phone calls with Joe Biggs. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. Please don't take the show for granted. We're under attack. I knew about demis. I read about it in history books decades ago, but then we have former Navy SEAL and writer Matt Bracken on about the whole Islamic invasion. He says, listen, when they let people kill folks in Europe, then politicians say it's not Islamic. That is the cue that they're operating as a good demi. And I go, look at Hollande and Merkel and all of them. And Hillary, they're getting hundreds of millions to their foundations and groups and clubs. And the thing is, these Muslim countries, almost everybody's slaves. There's these rich elites on top. And they're all about buying influence, taking over governments. And we're just totally laissez-faire and open. It's like we have no immune system. So my dad, who's a big history buff, he goes, shimmy means protected in Arabic. Dimmy, pronounced dimmy. And it goes, as is, you are legal to exist, but because you are buying a license to exist, you can pay over and over to be abused. Look up the modern dimmy contracts. Well, Dad, just bring them over here. If you're okay, yes, I know about dimmy contracts in Arabic from the Middle East and other areas. It's like when they bring in workers into Indonesia or some area that's Islamic, they tell them, look, you're going to pay higher taxes if you're not a Muslim. And so it is. And again, the first wave is all like friendly. Oh, I'm here to be your friend. Oh, I love you. Ah, and maybe they are the heretics. Maybe they are the folks that wanted to get away from it. But then now we're getting the new waves where they admittedly go to people's houses in France and say, you're going to give me a job, my family mayor, or I'm going to kill you. And the mayors capitulate because it's politically incorrect. And because the Muslims don't care if you arrest that group, their cousins will come kill you. And so now this new wave is from the very worst countries. These are the ones that invaded Syria from all over the Muslim world, got their butts kicked. So now Europe said, just come here, sweetie pies. I don't see how the leftists are going to get away with this, Joe Biggs.
What the leftists don't understand is the people that they want to bring in are the ones that are going to have a knife to their neck. They want to bring these kind of people in, but these are the exact same people that are going to go after them first. Why? Because they're the weaker of the humans.
Exactly. Why do the jihadis continue to attack mainly their own Democrat people? Because they have no respect for them?
They're lesser. I mean, look at how men, when I grew up and the heroes we had that we looked up to, you know, the John Waynes and, you know, all this stuff. We had all these people that we looked up to and we're like, man, that's what a man should be. Someone who fights for his family, fights for his land, fights for his country and doesn't back down. We don't have those kind of people anymore. We have no role models now because these men have been dumbed down so much. They're so nancified, so pussified. They are weak. They wear short shorts and, you know, they look like you can't tell the difference between a guy and a girl half the time. And these guys coming over, they grew up in war-torn countries. They're fighting every day for something they believe in, they truly believe in, and they're willing to die for. They're willing to strap a bomb to their chest and blow themselves up and kill whoever for what they believe in. And they see the people over here in Europe, they see the people here in America, and they go, wow, these people are weak.
So that's it. The left hates the open freedom. They hate the true liberalism that their fathers and mothers and forebears gave them. And so it's just like women that like abusive men or bad boys. It is Stockholm syndrome. And they're cuckolded. They really are dominated and think it's sexy and want to wear a burqa and be in a slave pit. I mean, they really want to be sold at bazaars in North Africa at a subconscious level. They hate daddy that gave them all this freedom, and they just want to crap all over the West and mutilate and bring everything down.
I grew up in the woods. I grew up with camo on my face and deer urine on me, in a tree stand, shooting a bow, taking out a deer, fishing, going out, building stuff. I mean, that's what I grew up
doing. You didn't play Pokemon Go?
No. My Pokemon were deer and hogs. I round those things up and threw them in a bag and eat them.
But
think about this. When you go talk about hunting now, when I go out in public here in Austin or around the country and I talk about hunting, people go, ooh, that's disgusting. And then you just throw it away. And I'm like, no, I clean it right there on the spot. I fillet it. I freeze it. Take it home. And I eat it. I provide for my family from the earth. And you have these men now that are just like, oh, that is so disgusting. Either way, we're going to go see a One Direction concert later. Like, what the hell is that? What is One Direction? The only direction you're moving in towards is being feminine as hell.
Well, and people call it feminine. I wouldn't even call it that. It's just they're so disconnected. And I'm not knocking people. This is the way the world works now. They've broken up the family. So your family is the trendy group you're in. Well, that's some artificially programmed system.
I don't know. I just think the death of the American man is starting to happen.
I think it's the death of responsibility, because I don't want to romanticize everything in the past either. But if you look at what they are, they just want to run the white flag up and bend over.
Yeah, they're weak. You don't see many people that are willing to jump up and put something on the line. Because like these jihadis, they're willing to strap a bomb to their chest. They're willing to load a 2-ton vehicle down with explosives and drive it into a building because they believe in it. We have no more. We hardly have any Americans that have conviction to really stand up
And that's why when you see people like Snowden or Assange, people who actually believe in something, are uncovering these truths and leaking this information to the public to expose these people, they're putting their lives on the line. We are putting our lives on the line. Not many people are willing to do that anymore.
Well, I'll just throw this out there as a one-liner, but it's true. People better not take InfoWars for granted. I don't mean that like, oh, you better appreciate us. We're fighting every day just to stay on air and to get the information out. They're bringing in censorship. It's intensifying by the moment. And people say, oh, well, once they shut down the press, I'll be okay. No, they're coming for everybody. They want to end prosperity because they can't compete with it. They want to sew this country up.
The enemy is probing us right now by Sadiq Mateen standing there behind a presidential frontrunner. He is probing. He is sending a message out there.
That, he was brought here by the CIA from the Taliban.
I'm okay to be here. So continue to come on. You guys are safe.
He's like, I'm at Orlando where my son, who followed the ideology I push, kill the gays, did this.
And I'm standing behind Hillary Clinton.
And I'm standing behind her. And there's nothing these Americans will do. We've conquered them. I'm planting the flag. You don't know how pathetic they are.
And they know that these leftists are going to sit back and go, oh, my God, we can't say anything because if we would have brought it up, then we could have been looked at as racist. And meanwhile, this guy comes up behind him with a blade and just cuts their head off. But they're willing to sit here and die for political correctness, but they're not willing to
die
for what America stands for.
Because they have created a thought system about to base their whole world on rationalizing their cowardice.
I know there's a lot of men and women out there who are willing to stand up and fight for stuff.
The problem is, though, the way they've compartmentalized everything, how do you do it? Well, you do it with information warfare. You do it with the truth. And you do it with you being the eyes and ears out there, like listeners did, to show that no one was there to see Hillary, but the media lied about it. You were the human intelligence on the ground that exposed that, put that out. Now it's the top of DrudgeReport.com. In fact, let's go to DrudgeReport.com right now. Paul Watson's article is up there on the very, very top, dealing with when will Mr. Mateen decry what his son did, and when will Hillary
disavow?
When will Hillary disavow? Will Hillary disavow Mateen endorsement? Let's click on that. That's the big question. The Mateen endorsement hashtag. We need to have that hashtag, saying, will she disavow?
But think about this. If this was Donald Trump at a rally right now in Kissimmee, Florida, and we would have spotted Sadiq Mateen in the background, what would have happened? That would have been
he was clearly brought in. He was clearly vetted.
Oh yeah.
He was placed behind. What message is Trump sending? How insensitive he is in the very town where the family's lost 50-something people. And there's the father himself of this homophobic YouTube channel and international TV program calling, for the eradication of these people. And then there he is gloating on top of the tombstones of the dead people. This is the end of Donald Trump.
Exactly. They would say his racist bigotry is what led to this. And this further shows that having
the
insensitivity in the background, that he has no sensitivity for the deaths of the homosexuals that died at the Pulse nightclub. And he's sending a message that it's okay to have this kind of bigotry towards people who are different than us.
This is pissing on the graves.
Yes,
I mean,
it
these
is.
People have gone.
And she is openly allowing
she
him
did
to piss
it.
On
they
it.
They stuck him because I've read about this. You've been there many times, but they admit going back decades. At these presidential things, and these candidates, who they put behind is key, the demographic,
yeah.
Who they place, and they put him right over her right shoulder. I mean, he is right there where you see his head the whole time. This guy that was on every TV station for a month.
Well, go back to the picture. He's actually wearing a red hat that looks like a Trump hat. But it's
hat.
Got that red hat, though. It almost looks like that's kind of purposely. Like,
it's all subliminal. Yeah. Here, let's go back and show it. I agree to you. I totally agree with you. This is sick, Joe.
But people are going to see that red hat. Some people who aren't going to get the actual correct coverage of what's going on, they're going to see him in the back with that red hat, and they're going to be like, oh, my God, he was back there with this red hat. It's much like Trump's hat. Trump, who's a racist and a bigot, and he hates.
They'll probably spin it and say endorse Trump.
Yeah, exactly.
That's how Hillary will respond. I want to take a few phone calls in the time we've got left. Let me give the number out. It's 800-259-9231. Then David Knight's coming in to take over. 800-259-9231. What do you think he's doing showing up in the tiny VIP section right behind her? But here's what's scary. More people in the VIP section that's all vetted and scripted than there were to see her. That's the even bigger story. It's like fraud on top of fraud on top of fraud. With this doddering lady up there, this is what Matt Drudge calls a twilight zone.
How many people were in that stadium or that little hall or whatever you want to call it that actually had friends or family who died in that shooting and no one said anything to this man, he should have been mobbed. People should have been going up like, why are you here? Like, why do you think it's even okay for you to be here based off the rhetoric you've been spewing for so long?
I'm surprised he went, I know it's your culture to kill gays, so thank you for carrying out your culture. Sorry about the bigots that, like, tried to block their faces when you shot them.
But think about that.
I think they should be tied up on telephone poles so you can shoot them slower, or maybe use a Saudi Arabian saber on their wee-wees.
Yeah, Trump supporters would have called that guy out in a second. Been like, what the hell are you doing here?
He would have gotten his ass kicked.
Yeah, within seconds.
Because he didn't come there to apologize.
No, he came there to gloat. Like, look, I'm still here. You want to know
hello,
why?
Hello, 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 hello.
Aloha snack bar. He was gloating. He's going, hey, I'm still here. My rhetoric is what caused my son to go out and do
this. Well, it's true. They've taken our life force away. They've taken our will to survive, to have kids, to live in the West, no matter what color we are. And they've just brought in like cavemen that are just ready to take over. All their emails, your women are ours, you're a weak. We will take their women, raw, kill the men.
What are our kids doing?
Oh, yes, kill us. Oh.
It's like age Skrillex. What are our kids doing? They're running around with a cell phone in their face trying to catch.
I hate the West.
You know what their kids are doing right now? Learning how to shoot. Learning how to survive on a small bag of rice.
Hello.
Learning how to build stuff.
Hello.
That's the thing, though. There's an actual war going on. And we're not getting prepared at all, overall.
Why are you being racist?
Hey, I've been there. I know what these people do. I know what goes on. I've seen kids coming out of bazaars throwing grenades at Humvees. These aren't normal kids. Our kids are throwing balls trying to pick up Pokemon Go. They're throwing grenades. They're learning how to fashion together.
And the difference is you guys were sent in to go after the non-radical country to bring it down, the enemy of Saudi Arabia. See how crazy that is?
Mm-hmm.
To then take Iraq over for the jihadists. I'm not blaming you guys, but see the larger.
Yeah.
See the how sick that is?
Yeah.
Our military thought they were fighting radical Islam when it was basically laying the path in for it.
Yeah. I mean, you got to think.
Disagree with me if you disagree with that statement.
No. I believe you, but you got to think the low guy on the totem pole.
No, I'm not blaming them. They don't know.
Yeah, we have.
No, I'm not. I'm saying, though.
We're given intel and we go, well, I guess that's what it is.
No, but I'm saying the good news is our military said no about the Syria deal. They've got it. So how does Obama and Hillary and the globalists put the genie back in the bottle now that the military gets the scam?
Well, they continue to put these reporters out that are leftist-leaning kind of people. So many people watch TV and get their information from that. They're controlling the narrative by having these kind of people like Anderson Cooper putting out all the information to the bulk of the people. That's how they do it. They control the narrative. Meanwhile, if you're an awake soldier, a veteran, whatever, it really doesn't matter because they're pushing all their stuff to the bulk people. And when you go out and you bring up the fact that there's radical Islam being brought into our country, the fact that the borders are wide open, they're all going to look at you and laugh and go,
well, look at the alliance.
Rachel Maddow said,
look at 9/11. If the event happens, the Wahhabist enemies get attacked, Iraq. Same thing now. The deal is bring them in, let them attack, take our rights when they attack.
Yeah, exactly.
There is a deal with Islam, with Wahhabism to take this country down.
I 100% believe that.
I mean, I remember hearing the FBI like 15 years ago would like, it's like Al-Qaeda knows what we're going to do before we do it. It's like they have moles above us. Well, yeah, it turns out that is what was happening.
Yeah.
Well, let's go to a few phone calls. Joe Biggs is our guest. Let me just add real quickly that we have 40% off the exercise, libido, stamina enhancer, the best organic formula we could come up with, the highest quality, super low price already, 40% off Anthroplex. That's our new special we're running right now on InfoWarsLife.com. Women can take it as well. Check it out. Read about it. Look at the 4.8 star reviews. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, and a lot of other specials as well. Let's go to, who should we go to first here? Let's go to Charles in Tennessee. You're on the air. Welcome.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. It's a pleasure to speak with you both. I just really wanted to take the opportunity to call in and say thank you for the work that you're doing. Give a shout-out to Sergeant Joe Biggs there. I've never had the pleasure of actually getting to call and speak with you, Air Assault. And, certainly appreciate your service, sir. I was, fortunate enough to be able to serve my country as well. Alex, I just really wanted to say thank you for everything you do. God bless you all. God bless.
Well, please don't thank me because I'm going to say this, and I got a pet peeve on this. You guys are more important than we are, giving us the information on the ground, supporting us, spreading the word. You're just as important as we are. We're all in this with you too, brother. How do we get the word out to the public that's somewhat awake but not fully awake?
You know, sir, I've continued to try to do what I can at the grassroots level and speak with my friends and family and just try to have open dialogue and conversation with them. I'm trying to get websites and stuff organized. I think that's a good way to do it as well. You know, I think as far as like with voter registration and potential voter fraud, that sort of thing needs to be addressed. Even if it's just we all have a website where we can go in and say, hey, I voted for such and such. I want to go on record that says I voted for so-and-so. Prove me wrong.
I agree. Everybody should go out and do exit polls to just show. Hey, I talked to 100 people. 70% were for Trump. They're showing different. That's how we're going to burn them. That's how we're going to resist them. And separately, everybody should be copying stories off InfoWars, Prison Planet, and other important sites so that if they take us down, you can put it back up. Because believe me, folks, it is getting bad. It is. They are really trying to shut things down right now. Look, the coup over Fox 3 weeks ago, they suddenly, you watch it, It is, except for Hannity, they have taken that channel over.
Yeah, Hannity's the last true guy out there, really.
He's not perfect.
In the mainstream.
But the point is, they're trying to shut him down right now. I mean, Fox is gone, folks. It is gone. I mean, that shows you they are moving in.
But why aren't Americans pissed off at the fact that illegals can come into this country and vote without registering, without doing anything, and be allowed to go do that, have their vote count multiple times? But me, I can't even go to Top Golf in North Austin without registering to get a Top Golf card to even go hit a golf ball. Or if I want to go fly, I have to show my ID, which I have to maintain. I have to go.
You're being racist. You're being racist. No, the Democrats in multiple states, in multiple cities, California, Illinois, others, have had bills to let illegals vote. Like, why are you against illegals? I can't go to China and vote. What? Of course, they don't even have votes.
I can't go outside the VA and get health care unless the VA goes, okay, you can go outside to a better doctor, which never hardly happens.
Thank you. God bless you, Charles. More calls straight ahead with Joe Biggs. I'm Alex Jones. Infowars.com. While it's still there, please spread the word. Joe Biggs is my co-host right now. Coming up, David Knight takes over in about 10 minutes. I'm going to do 5 more minutes in the next hour. Who should we go to? Hans, Anthony, Kennan, Mike, John, who's been holding the longest here? Let's go to Hans in Pennsylvania. You're on the air.
Yes. Good afternoon, gentlemen. I've been an avid listener of your show for quite a while, and I'm very well aware of what the New World Order is doing to us. And I'm an inventor. I kind of think out of the box on occasion, and the thought occurred to me that this government continuity of government program that has been in effect for years might present a possible means for the New World Order to decapitate our entire government in one fell swoop. For example...
Sure, it's set up for outside globalists to have a total track into everything to be able to bring down our nation anytime they want. That's actually the secret of world government, is that they then hold the technotronic technocracy keys above it and can take down any country they want whenever they want. So you've hit the nail on the head there. It's kind of like Operation Valkyrie in reverse.
If they stage a false attack or if there's some sort of a major emergency where they can get all of the members of Congress into these underground facilities, these facilities are already set up with air ventilation, and it would be relatively simple for them to just nerve gas everybody in one fell swoop and decapitate the entire government. And also, if members of the military are ordered to go into these facilities at the same time, they would...
Yeah, that's who you got to worry about, is the Patriots. Listen, Warren Buffett called top billionaires the week before 9/11 and said, it's all expenses paid, it's secret, I can't tell you. You need to fly into Omaha on this night. And then they were off at Air Force Base in the morning with big screen TVs. And it's all secret what happened as the towers were hit. And a few that have leaked it said they were called there, quote, for their safety. Can you believe that? So, yeah, it's amazing, man. They know what they're doing. But he's such a nice old man.
Yeah.
He loves Obama, though. That's an interesting point, Hans. Anything else?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. If you remember that movie where he gets all the crime bosses into this one facility of his and he nerve gasses them and takes all their money, this is something similar to what they're going to do to our members of Congress. And these people better realize that they think they've earned a seat at the table, but in reality, they're just dooming themselves. Once they enter these facilities, I don't think they'll be coming out of them again.
Yeah, you're talking about the old Goldfinger written by Ian Fleming, MI6.
Yeah, yeah.
Let me expand on that, and I appreciate your call.
That's kind of an allegory for what happens under any totalitarian system throughout the ages, that the people that help overthrow the free state, they then are the first people killed by the actual controllers that brought them in. So, yes, the dumbest people are the ones that go along with the takeover. A lot of times they'll flip it back to a more populist movement, the elite will, because that's more stable. Once they've taken out the elite, a lot of times a takeover isn't even about robbing the general public. You just hit it. It's about knocking out the political class. Joe?
Yeah, I agree completely. Like I said, we've pussified these people so much. The left are crying. They want to bring in these radical jihadis. But who do they think are going to be the first ones to take them out? It's going to be the guys that they're fighting for.
Huffington Post and others over and over again say, wear a burqa, cover your face, make the Muslims feel good, plus it's sexy.
And now you have Obama coming out. He did this interview on the Golf Channel the other day where he goes, well, I really don't want to get out. I'm being forced out. And he's joked many times about how.
Yeah, by the way, you guys cue that up. It's only like a 30-second clip. He's on there with that FOP guy, and then go ahead. Oh, we have it. Here, let's play the FOP clip right now. Here it is.
Days, have you taken any divots out of the south lawn here?
The rough's a little thick here. I don't practice that much. I'm not a hack, but I'm not quitting my day job. I'd say
you are quitting your day job fairly shortly.
Well, then I may get good. I'm being forced out. I didn't quit.
That's good. And again, I'm not against. This guy's a dandy. And he interviewed George Herbert Walker Bush and W. And W, in the last interview with that guy, is literally wearing a dandy outfit. We'll be right back. You know how my psychology works? I know Fox News has been controlled opposition forever to control the libertarian movement. But to know they had a coup, to know they've come in, know they have this suit planned for years, right before the election, because they can't have Fox challenging a stolen election, really is a bellwether. It's a canary in the coal mine. It is the biggest canary in the coal mine. And I really haven't even been covering it because it's almost like I'm celebrating over a dead corpse. Not that it was perfect, but I really should be, because I'm watching it. It's definitely gone, you know, Hillary now. And you can see him putting the disinfo out. And it's almost like I'd be celebrating over a dead corpse if I attack it, but I have to. It's crazy. It's absolutely crazy that they really did it. And let me tell you, Drudge and InfoWars is next. Speaking of Drudge, I'm told it's now the top story on Drudge. We'll put that on screen. Twilight Zone, Orlando Terrace dad cheers Clinton. Will Hillary disavow? And that's our story. So again, that's just common sense. We put it out. Drudge links to it. Now it'll be a major talking point if you get the story out to everyone you know.
And yet they hammer Trump nonstop about David Duke. There should be people, media, do your job. There should be people out there right now on every channel going, wow, Sadiq Mateen was back there in Orlando.
Give me a break. The Ku Klux Klan is completely Democrat. Every Grand Dragon there ever was a Democrat.
What, was Robert Byrd?
And quite frankly, David Duke is right about we can't just have wide open borders and that there's an anti-white agenda of balkanization. It doesn't mean he's right about white sheets and dancing around in a KKK outfit. Mecha and La Raza are right about the exploitation of Hispanics in many cases. It doesn't mean they're right about, you know, all their crap.
Yeah.
I mean, look, they're going, oh, Alex Jones agrees with David Duke. I agree exactly. With being intellectually honest, okay? You know, I mean, the Imperial Japanese, I didn't agree with them doing secret testing on our troops. But yes, we did cut off their oil. We did cut off their rubber. The West did push them into that. Does that mean I agree with what the Japanese did? No. It's reality-based, Joe.
I mean, look at all the media now. Now that Fox has completely gone Clinton, mostly, you've only got InfoWars, Breitbart, and Michael Savage, who are the other people who are giving you that other side.
And by the way,
what's going on?
We sit around here. Are we excited about there's so few of us?
No, it's good that we have the people, but it's kind of sad sometimes. That
no, exactly. It's not fun.
A lot of people out there that are on that side.
It's creepy. Kind of, it's creepy.
Yeah, it's like we're all alone in this one big, like, Clinton rally, and we're the only ones there.
But because there's no one showing up to the rally.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like a total hoax. We're there calling.
We're just there yelling.
They're shutting the media down.
We're just there bullhorning her, and she's just sitting there going.
Well, I mean, my point is I'm not in competition against Drudge. I'm not in competition against Breitbart. I'm not in competition against WorldNet Daily or Daily Caller. I mean, and none of us are perfect, but at least we don't want to destroy the country. And then I find
the real Hillary supporters. And Joe, it's like they're not home.
Oh, yeah, I like Hillary Clinton. It's like the one guy that Rob talked to out there in Philadelphia.
Disturbing.
Guy was out of his mind. The other guy goes, yeah, take the gun, sweep him up, get rid of him.
Hey, what did you think about? What did you think about it's a Daily Show or one of these things?
Eric Andre.
Oh, that one. But somebody else did a clip where they go out and they ask questions, but say they quote Trump, but say it was Hillary, and they all agree with it.
Yeah,
that's the thing we found. You could say we want to put babies in blenders for Hillary, they'd say yes.
Oh, of course.
It was Jimmy Kimmel. In fact, we have that clip. We got to play that. Is David Knight coming in this studio or the other one? So he's being the other one. Well, that means we can come back and play the Jimmy Kimmel clip. And in fact, we have it right now. We're going to come back and play that after the break. And David Knight is going to be taking over. We got loaded phone lines. That will be up to David Knight. These are some good callers. They have been holding long if he wants to take those phone calls. But I shouldn't be laughing about all this. It's either that or cry.
Well, it's like in combat. It's ridiculous. You have to learn to laugh at some of this stuff. If not, you're going to go crazy.
I had to go nuts or I'd go crazy.
Well, Hillary Clinton's already gone nuts.
Oh, man, I can't look at her anymore. I cannot look at her. Joe Biggs is with me. We got David Knight in the other studio about to hand the baton. Nightly news coming up tonight, 7 o'clock Central Standard Time. I want to thank all the viewers and listeners and affiliates and sponsors for making this possible. Please stop thanking me. It is so humbling when we're out in public, Joe Biggs, and we run into sometimes thousands of listeners and fans over a weekend at the RNC or DNC. It's very humbling. Families and their little kids and just really, and all of them, their eyes are so alive, whether they be black or white or Hispanic or Asian. And it's just amazing to see it. And it's disproportionate black Americans. I mean, I got to say, InfoWars disproportionately has always had a larger group of, you know, instead of 13% of the population, I'd say in the United States, 20, 30% of our population is black. And I'm not going to patronize, call you African Americans. It's a new name every week. Black folks are sick of all of it. Just, I mean, I'm a pink folk. I kind of got, you know, goofy looking skin. But the point is that we're Americans. We all got red blood. And people are sick of being put in these boxes. And I tell you, the fact that Hillary can't get crowds anywhere, again, it's indicative she's not really ahead of Trump. And then we get the nomenclature. We get the diagnostics. We get the methodology, the breakdown from Reuters and AP and others. On all these polls where Hillary surged 10 to 15 points, they added 15% more Democrats. This is not brain surgery here, folks. I mean, what do you make of this?
You get on social media, Donald Trump's exploding. He's everywhere. He's all over Reddit.
Way
He's
bigger than Hillary.
Facebook, Twitter, everything.
Instagram. By the censorship.
There's larger amount of accounts that are pro-Trump than there are Hillary Clinton. And when you look at the Hillary Clinton pages, guess what they are? Hillary for prison, handcuff Hillary, Hillary doesn't belong here, you know, Hillary for San Quentin, all this stuff.
By the way, that was in the article about it. Hillary's most popular thing on social media is Hillary for prison.
Yeah, exactly, and that is amazing.
I'm sorry, it's funny. I want to play this clip and then go to, in fact, but first, David, I want to play this clip from one of the national TV shows. Who is it, Jimmy Kimmel?
Yeah.
Where they do the same methodology we do, whether it's Austin or whether it's Cleveland or whether it's Philadelphia or whether it's L.A., our reporters or our auxiliary reporters, like Mark Dice, he gets criticized. So do we. They go, why'd you just show dumb people? We're not doing that.
There's a lot of dumb
people. We are showing you basically everyone that had something to say, and 8 out of 10 in Austin Democrats want gun owners in forced labor and want to execute us. 8 out of 10 want to kill newborn babies or up to age 3.
Post-birth abortion.
8 out of 10 want to ban homes bigger than 250 square feet. I mean, this is a cult of psychopaths. I mean, these are lunatics. I don't know what you call them. I'm not a psychiatrist. But I know this. They're freaking crazy. But you got to add one thing. For Obama, for Hillary. And that's what Jimmy Kimmel's show illustrated. Look at David Knight's take on it is, if you say it's for Hillary, if you say Hillary said it, they will support it. That's called being in a cult. If Donald Trump came out and said, I want compulsory national service and I want you to worship me as God, I'd say, I'm done with Trump. He's crazy, blah, blah, blah. But see, not with them. If you had a cult follower, well, Trump wants everybody to drink cyanide Kool-Aid, they'd say, yes, yes, drink it. But see, Trump isn't doing that. This is literal cult behavior. Let's go to the clip.
What did you think? think when Hillary Clinton said, I see improved relations with Russia from a position of strength only as possible?
I agree with Hillary.
Hillary Clinton said, immigration is a privilege and we should not let anyone into this country who doesn't support our communities, all of our communities.
Well, I'd virtually have to agree with that.
Hillary said, in order to achieve the American dream, let people keep more money in their pockets and increase after-tax wages.
Yes, okay. It's in order, that's a great idea so that we can start to move everybody up and start moving people out of the level of poverty.
And obviously runs fairly severe contrast to what Donald Trump is proposing.
Absolutely. Many of her comments run severe contrast to Donald Trump.
What do you think of this quote from Hillary? There's nothing I love more than women, but they're really a lot different than portrayed. They're far worse than men, far more aggressive, and boy, can they be smart.
I agree. I've worked for 38 years in the hospital with women, and that's a very accurate.
And you think that's obviously a sharp contrast to her opponent?
Absolutely.
Hillary Clinton said, I like the concept of local education. I want to get rid of Common Core. I think Common Core is a disaster.
Well, I'm an educator. I'm a school teacher. I think Common Core is a disaster, too.
And what do you think of this Hillary quote? I have never seen a thin person drinking Diet Coke.
Never seen a thin person drinking Diet Coke. Well, let me tell you something. Diet Coke does not make you thin.
So you would say, get rid of Common Core, keep the Diet Coke.
Keep the Diet Coke.
Exactly.
What do you think of this Hillary Clinton quote? I am opposed to gay marriage.
Well, I've heard that a lot from a lot of politicians. It's all about the timing, though, isn't it? No, hey, she's for us now. Yay!
She did actually.
I'll take that as a win.
What did you think of this quote from Hillary Clinton? While Bette Midler is an extremely unattractive woman, I refuse to say that because I always insist on being politically correct.
I am sure that she never said that.
You're right. Please don't say that.
I can't make any guarantees.
So the one Democratic operative, kind of a master spider, got what it was. David Knight, is that not illustrative? Like, we're not out trying to make people look dumb. We show the people this is how crazy they are. If you just say it's for Hillary or Obama, they go along with
David,
it.
David actually spoke to this lady at the DNC and laid out every reason why she shouldn't be president. She goes, well, I still think she's trustworthy.
Oh, yeah. Talked about all the different issues with leaking information, you know, because she's trying to sell this idea that Donald Trump had some kind of alliance with the Russians to hack the DNC. Alex, I spent a week at the DNC talking to these very people. It is a herd mentality. They need a T-shirt that says, I'm with herd. Because that's really what it is. There's a great political cartoon that we tweeted out. My wife saw it. I tweeted it out as well. There's all these sheep around at the Democrat convention, and they're saying she would never do anything bad, you know, and she would never pull the wool over our eyes, okay? They are sheep. No matter what you tell them, they always say, you know, she's loyal and trustworthy and honest, and, you know, you can't convince them otherwise.
Why does Hillary have armed guards, but you can't? Why does Mexico have borders that we can't?
You know, Alex, there's an update. Mikhail Thelen just handed me a new story at Infowars.com. WikiLeaks is not convinced at all that Russia had anything to do with it. Of course, they were the ones who released the information.
Sure, more evidence points towards its own, our own private intelligence.
Yes, but they just put out, tweeted out, a $20,000 reward for information on the murdered DNC staffer Seth Rich.
Who
was beaten. WikiLeaks did.
Wow.
They put out a $20,000 reward for information about this DNC staffer who was beaten,
shot to death. Wow, that goes towards what you were saying earlier, and others were saying that may be the leak source.
Yeah, because he was a data analyst for the DNC.
Oh, my God.
They said if anybody could have gotten a hold of that information, it would have been him.
Assange better release his info now. He's not safe in that embassy.
And then Assange said that it was not Russia, so definitely it could point to someone like this. And then it's going to go to who else had ties with Seth Rich and who else had that kind
of
access.
That's like five different DNC people, three of them involved with the technicals dying in the last month.
And of course, he was beaten and shot, and he was not robbed, okay? I know this is D.C., and it's a model of a criminal city, but he was not robbed. So, you know, all these different things, of course, it's just a conspiracy theory, I'm sure Hillary Clinton would say.
I mean, he could have shot himself in the back of the head twice. That's kind of normal.
Yeah, don't be racist against bullets.
Yeah.
Getting serious here, though. Wow, WikiLeaks is coming out and saying this. Well, Assange has pointed out that what he's got is supposedly going to bring down Hillary. I don't know what he's waiting for, David.
I don't know. I mean, he is. I've got another article from Julian Assange. He went on Russia Today, and he talked about the fact that, of course, this is an article from Steve Watson that's on Infowars.com. Assange pointed out the fact that Trump really doesn't have any connections in Russia. He hasn't been able to build any hotels since Putin took office there. So he doesn't have any influence there. He can't even get a hotel built. And yet Hillary Clinton, as he pointed out, was involved in that massive uranium deal that we've talked about for so long.
Well, he said that she's got more connections to Russia than anybody he's ever seen, except for the Saudis, and she's totally run by them.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah, that's a key point, is the Saudi Arabian
connection.
And by the
way, that's what Russia's supposed to do with its intelligence agencies, is fight for Russia. Mm-hmm. And then we're supposed to fight for us, and Putin gets that. It's just we're not going to have nuclear war with each other.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't understand why people are so obsessed with like wanting to make them our enemy. When we have one candidate in Trump who wants to make him an ally, leave him be. Let them do what they want to do.
Look at all the Islamic terror. It'd be perfect to link up with Russia.
Yeah, you know, when we look at what's going on with Russia, I had these two women that I talked to that were there at the convention trying to lobby on behalf of Ukraine. One of them wanted to sell the idea that Donald Trump was involved with the Russians to take down the DNC. She was the one that I went back and forth with and said, really, do you understand the history of how the security establishment has come after legitimate whistleblowers like Thomas Drake? Do you understand that? Do you understand what she really did and how she exposed people? Many people, they believe, died because of her security leaks. And then the other woman wanted to push for the fact that we needed to step things up and send in lethal aid to Ukraine to fight the Russians and the Crimea. And I said, really, you think we really want to go to war in order to stop this dispute of secession and civil war between Crimea and the Ukraine? Of course, she thinks that Ukraine should secede from Russia, but not Crimea from Ukraine.
And she doesn't even know that George Soros started the whole thing to begin with Hillary. And again, not bashing women, but it is archetypal to have all these weird power-tripping women in super suits and fancy outfits blustering how they're going to kick the Russians' butts. It just reeks of idiocy. It's crazy. And it won't help our country either, but it'll help the big defense contractors. David Icke takes over.
We were just talking about a breaking story. WikiLeaks offering a $20,000 reward for information on the murder of a DNC staffer. That's Seth Rich, who was beaten and shot to death in D.C. We're going to have more on that story, as well as more information about what Julian Assange said about Hillary, what Hillary said about WikiLeaks. We're going to have all that back and forth, as well as, of course, the top story on Drudge Report is Twilight Zone. Orlando terrorist dad cheers the Clintons, okay? And will Hillary disown this? That's the question. And so we're going to cover that. That's our story at Infowars.com by Paul Joseph Watson. We're going to take a look at what we've now learned about Hillary's biggest Taliban. That's what the Daily Caller calls him. Of course, we've got the Taliban now, and we've got Sharia Khan, a couple of guys. I think it's very telling, the hypocrisy of Hillary Clinton. But before we get to those stories, I want to play for you some other breaking information that we've got here. This is an exclusive we got here. This is a new phone call message that's been intercepted. This was sent from Ahmadinejad to Barack Obama. But, of course, they're friends. So Ahmadinejad, understand, calls him Barry. You'll hear him call him Barry in this clip. Let's run that clip.
Jerry. Yeah, what can I do for you?
Show me the money.
Yeah, Barry, show me the money, okay? Ahmadinejad is telling Obama, even after all of this cash just broke this last week, I guess he decided it was time to double down and really punish his good friend Barry. And so he's telling him, come on, man, you still have time to send me the other $2 billion I say you owe me, okay? If he was Jewish, they would call that chutzpah, okay? But he's not. He's Iranian, okay? Now, he sends him this letter, and it begins with a traditional Islamic greeting, assalamu alaikum, I guess, if that's the way you pronounce it. I'm sure I will become much more of an expert with all the Muslims that we're bringing into this country. I'll be able to pronounce that precisely very shortly, I'm sure. But he went on to say, your campaign slogan was change. You claim to be determined to change those policies as well as your behavior. So, in other words, Barry, send me the money. Send me your change. All your change, you can send it in any kind of currency you want. Just put it on the plane and fly it over. You know, they had to have a plane to get that $400 million worth of cash in foreign currency to them. I wonder how many planes it would take to get $2 billion. You know, we could could work that out mathematically with a lot of how many pallets would that be? But remember that in April, the Supreme Court ruled that Iranian assets worth $2 billion must be paid to American families whose relatives were killed in Beirut and Saudi Arabian military attacks that the U.S. government said were the cause of Iran. They took place in 1983, 1996, the Khobar Tower bombings. Understand how this is rolled out by the Democrats, okay? We had Hillary Clinton say, hey, this is an old story. No, it's an old conspiracy, okay? This is something we didn't learn about until last Wednesday. It's not even been a week. But immediately she said, this is an old story. What was new about it was the fact that we saw for a fact that Wall Street Journal and others uncovered the fact that this was done as a money laundering expedition. And of course, as a National Review pointed out, you know, they went through various phases, okay? They say, well, this is an old story. It's already been talked about. I'm not going to talk anymore about it. That's Hillary's approach. Of course, the media covers for them and say, you know, hey, Donald Trump is talking about that. He's looking at B-roll. That's not an actual plane. Then when we started to say, well, it's ransom, you know, they said, well, no, it was just a coincidence that they picked the day that the hostages are going to be released to release this $400 million in foreign currency from a Swiss bank, a Swiss central bank, put it on a secret flight to send it to. And that was all just a coincidence. OK, but then we had the hostage pastor come out and say, no, we were told we were held overnight for many, many hours. We had to sleep there. We were told you're not leaving until the other plane gets here. So, okay, now it's a ransom. We can call it iRansom, okay? That's what it ought to be, the instead of a, you know, Watergate or some ransom gate or what. It should be called the iRansom story here. Now, Barack Obama said, well, we had to do that. We can't just write them a check. A National Review said, that's right, you can't just write them a check because that would be a violation of law. That would be a violation of your own sanctions that you have renewed every year, that have been renewed every year since 1995 when Bill Clinton put them on Iran. Okay? Understand the fact that when the Department of Justice said, we don't want you to do this, they weren't saying they weren't didn't want to do that because it was bad policy. That was because it was illegal. And let me read you some of the laws here, okay? Just 5 months ago, as a matter of fact, after iRansom, Obama said, Iran has been designated, this is his statement, okay, has been designated a state sponsor of terrorism in 1984. Iran has continued its terrorist-related activities in 2015. And then, of course, the law says the exportation, sale, supply, directly or indirectly from the U.S., okay, wherever it's located, is prohibited. On the very same day they got the hostages and gave them the secret payoff, the Treasury Department said the clearing of U.S. dollar or currency-denominated transactions is prohibited, and that is punishable as a felony with up to 20 years in prison. But, of course, we have reached the point in America where powerful people are not punished according to the law, just the rest of us. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, and we're going to return to more political intrigue and hypocrisy and lies in just a moment. But before we do, I want to talk to you about something serious. Dog sperm. Yes. This is a story from the Drudge Report, and it actually is quite serious because, you know, the dogs in this case are really kind of like canaries in a coal mine. Things happen more quickly to dogs and other animals because they have a shorter lifespan. What this story tells us is something we've been telling you about the food supply for a very long time. And what they're talking about here, quite frankly, the sperm quality in dogs has fallen rapidly over the past three decades. This is a trend, they said, that could help to explain the decline in human fertility. We're seeing throughout the West, and it's been blamed on sociological issues. We've seen a lot of people say, well, you know, it's just as we become more, we have this modern lifestyle, and women are interested in their careers, and they're delaying childbearing. And yes, all those things are contributing factors, okay? But when you look at a situation where throughout the West, you're now getting to reproduction rates that are just barely above one. You have to be over two in order to even maintain your population. So we see throughout Europe, for example, the Italians who just a couple of generations ago used to have an average 5-6 kids or more in their families, all of a sudden that dropped to the lowest in Europe. So they're just barely over one. Now, it's not strictly sociological. I believe, and many other people believe, that there are physiological things that are going on that are tied to the kinds of things that we're exposed to in terms of our food, the additives that go into our food, in terms of chemicals that we're exposed to in the environment. And this is what they're seeing, of course, in the dogs, because it's going to show up in dogs more quickly. They say they highlighted a potential link between environmental contaminants and fertility. Scientists discovered chemicals which have a detrimental effect on sperm function and some commercially available pet foods. Understand that it's not significantly different for humans either. The difference is they can see these effects more quickly and they can do more tests on the dogs than they're going to do on humans, okay? They say this is the first time such a decline in male fertility has been reported in the dog, and we believe this is due to environmental contaminants, some of which we have detected in dog food and in the sperm and in the testes of the dogs themselves, okay? This is from the New Scientist. This is one of the reasons that we have the kind of products that we have here, folks. We're not selling products and then creating a need to sell these products. There is a need for these products. That's why Alex has created these. And so we have products like Super Male Vitality, like Anthroplex, that are designed to help you fight these kind of environmental challenges that you have, the kind of estrogen or the hormonal disruptions. And, of course, there are things that disrupt estrogen in women as well. And we have products for that as well. We have a special right now on Anthroplex, 40% off at InfoWarsLife.com. 40% off. That is a huge sale, okay? Also, we have other sales. We have Premium Power Pack, 20% off at InfoWarsStore.com. And I believe we still have InfoWarsStore.com free shipping. Is that correct, guys? Yeah, we still have that. Okay, so everything at the store is free shipping, but also, as you're looking at what's going on in our environment, what's in your food, think about what you need to do to try to combat that. Of course, you can get cleaner sources of food, and that's very important. But there's so many different ways that you can be exposed to environmental contaminants in food and other chemicals. Take things that will actually help your system, things like Anthroplex, and it's 40% off at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, I want to go to some videos that we have of Hillary Clinton and Julian Assange. There's a back and forth going on. Of course, Hillary Clinton is just dismissing this stuff as a bunch of conspiracy theories. But I want to play for you the video that we have of Julian Assange talking about the Russian, supposed Russian connection with Donald Trump.
Any Russian connections between Hillary Clinton and Russia? Any Russian connections there?
Hillary Clinton has done quite well strategically to try and draw connection between Trump and Russia because she has so many connections of her own. Now, my analysis of Trump and Russia is that there is no substantial connection. Why do I say that? Well, because Trump was trying to invest in Russia before Putin in the 1990s, after Putin, in fact, nearly all the way up to the present moment, and he's had no success. He did not manage to build hotels and so on in Russia. So that shows how insubstantial his contacts are. There's an extremely well-documented pattern of when Hillary Clinton was Secretary of State, those people, companies, governments, who wanted a decision by the Secretary of State in their favor, making large donations to the Clinton Foundation, or in some other cases, business deals with the people around Hillary Clinton. Now, one particular instance is the approval by Secretary Clinton of selling 20% of the U.S. uranium reprocessing rights to a Russian company to be exported to Russia. So at that time, a large donation was made by those Russian interests to the Clinton Foundation. In addition, Clinton's campaign manager, Podesta, was on the board of a company called Juul Unlimited. And Juul Unlimited held some of these rights and received a $35 million investment from Russia.
And that's a Russian government company.
And also, Russians were on the board also with Podesta.
So the kind of email revelations from WikiLeaks reveal that Hillary Clinton is a Kremlin stooge.
I wouldn't say Kremlin stooge, but there is a much deeper connection on record with Hillary Clinton and Russia than we are presently aware of with Donald Trump.
I wouldn't say she's a Kremlin stooge either. I would say she is a corrupt politician who is for sale to anyone for any amount, okay? Remember what he just said there. 20% of U.S. uranium capacity was sold to the Russians, and it was a sweetheart deal for Hillary Clinton's close friend and advisor, Podesta, okay? But, of course, there's also connections to Saudi Arabia. I want to play what Julian Assange said about Saudi Arabia.
What is the connection between Hillary Clinton and Saudi Arabia that certainly got Israel angry?
Well, it's extensive. I mean, the relationships between Hillary Clinton and Saudi Arabia, between the Clinton Foundation and Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is probably the largest single donor to the Clinton Foundation. You can see Clinton's arms export policies, why she was Secretary of State, favoring extensively Saudi Arabia.
Yeah, William.
Absolutely. And, you know, there's a story at Breitbart pointing out how Hillary Clinton's State Department rubber-stamped visas for a record number of Saudi visitors. Remember that they gave, they're bragging about the fact that they gave Hillary Clinton 20% of her campaign funds. We'll get to that in just a moment. We've talked about that before as well. But it's important to remember this, to put this all in context. Say, despite, this is Breitbart, despite evidence that Saudi Arabian terrorists exploit the U.S. visa program, and that would be the visa program, the EB-5 visa program that Khazir Khan, or as I like to call him, Sharia Khan, specialized in. Okay, he specialized in getting people from Saudi Arabia and some other Arabian countries into this country using that visa program, EB-5, which has been flagged by a lot of people in Congress as well as Homeland Security as being a very fraudulent system, one that is fraught with a lot of security issues. But this is what she did for them as Secretary of State. She doubled the number of visas for Saudi visitors while helping to cut a deal with the kingdom to waive security procedures for Saudi nationals. With their arrival, the U.S. Counter-Jihad has learned. They point out that annual number of non-immigrant visas issued to Saudi nationals soared 93% during her tenure as Secretary of State. They said that it also would allow Saudi visa holders, this is what Hillary Clinton did, allowed Saudi visa holders to enter the U.S. as, quote, trusted travelers. Okay? They could bypass normal border security processes. Trusted travelers. You know, kind of like George Bush trusted the bin Ladens and flew them out the day after 9/11 on 9/12. He flew them out even as they were blaming Osama bin Laden for the 9/11 terrorist attacks. They fly his family out. And, of course, we've seen the connections in the 28 pages. We know how closely Saudi intelligence is linked with the CIA. We know that they are linked with the Federal Reserve, the petrodollar that was created by Nixon and Kissinger. But to say that they're trusted travelers, no, really, I think she meant to say they were trust fund travelers, you know, the people who give her the cash, who provide her with her trust fund. This story that we've covered before as well from Zero Hedge, where Saudi Arabia bragged that they'd funded 20% of Hillary's presidential campaign, okay? And understand, this happened at the same time as the Orlando shooting. So when we look at this Twilight Zone headline that Drudge is featuring at the Drudge Report today, the fact that you would have the father of the Orlando shooter at her rally, as Biggs has pointed out, that she would that they would vet him and deliberately put him behind her. That's not something that just anybody that goes to the rally gets to be behind the candidate. They would let him go to the rally, put him behind her. This is a statement that was made as the Orlando shooting took place. Hillary Clinton said, "It is long past time for the Saudis, for the Qataris, for the Kuwaitis and others to stop their citizens from funding extremist organizations. And they should stop supporting radical schools and mosques around the world that have set so many young people on a path towards extremism." Yet she's the one who doubled the number of people coming in from Saudi Arabia. She's the one who made them trusted travelers, okay, greasing the skids for these people. Why? Because of money. That's why. So you got her doing this and making this speech right as the Orlando shooting is taking place. You've got her putting Khazir Khan, the guy who supports Sharia law, who has commented on it many times, who's written fawning reviews of the analyses and the papers about Sharia law that have been done by the founder of the Muslim Brotherhood and others. She chooses that guy to speak just before she accepts the nomination. The guy who supports a system of law, and understand this, folks, Islam is not just simply a religion. It is a theocracy that they are selling you, okay? It is a unification of church and state. These are the Democrats who go to such lengths to say that no expression of Christianity is allowed because we must maintain this extreme separation of church and state. So you're not free to practice your religion if you're a Christian. But if you're a Muslim and you want to throw women off the bus and gays under the bus, then you are welcome to introduce Hillary Clinton when you support that kind of Sharia law. And then she comes out and talks about how dangerous the Saudis are as the Orlando shooting is going on. But there was a report, and this is one thing that we didn't really talk about in detail off of this Zero Hedge article a couple of weeks ago. When this article came out, this information was put out by the Petra News Agency, okay? And what they had were comments from the Saudi Deputy Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman. It included the claim that Riyadh had provided 20% of the total funding to Hillary's campaign. Now, they deleted that report, but however, we have a screenshot of it. And if you look at that screenshot, it's very important. They say the important part of Prince Mohammed bin Salman's statements before traveling to America, this is their summary of it. This travel is to strengthen extensive economic relations, that kind of boilerplate language, okay? Our minor differences with America on some issues don't damage our rooted relations with America. The two countries are strategic allies, so forth and so on. Saudi kings have always received necessary and sufficient support from the presidents of the United States. Yeah, like we put them in the catbird seat with the petrodollar, okay? They agreed to back up our worthless currency, and we agreed to do anything for the Saudis. Then they go on to say this. Saudi Arabia has sponsored both Republican and Democrat Party of America in America. Current elections also provide with full enthusiasm, I'm reading this just as they wrote it, 20% of the cost of Hillary Clinton's election. Get that? 20% of the cost of Hillary Clinton's election, even though some events in the country don't have a positive look, to support a woman for presidency. You know, because the Saudis are all about women in leadership positions. I mean, I covered a report not long ago about how the women in Saudi Arabia went nuts over having one night a week in an amusement park where they could go in and wear regular clothes and not have to dress themselves in a shroud. And they could drive bumper cars because they can't get behind the wheel of a car outside of the little bumper car arena on ladies' night. Okay, they could go in there, they could watch movies, they could dress normally, they could even drive a little bumper car. And they loved that release from a little bit of the pressure put on them by the religious police of Saudi Arabia. The people who, by the way, last year, that's that article. Great job, guys. You found that. Look at that. They're dressed in the burqas. But actually, they don't have to dress in the burqas on ladies' night. They can take off the burqas when they go around there. That little bit of freedom. You know, these are the people that are supporting Hillary Clinton. But she says it's just a conspiracy. Okay. There's no limit. The Trump campaign has never met a conspiracy theory it didn't like. Well, you know what? If you want to look at a conspiracy theory, again, go back and look at what Barack Obama did with iRansom. Okay. Look at that. Now, as we're looking at some of this other news, while we're on Democrats here, okay. This is a breaking story that Michael Zimmerman gave me, hat tip to Michael. He says, fresh off of his campaign to make socialism great again, Bernie Sanders buys a $600,000 summer house. Okay, understand, this is not his primary home. He's still going to keep his primary home. This is just a summer home that he just bought now that the campaign is over. And I look at this and it's like, well, you know, everybody's wondering, you know, what Bernie's price was. Was he threatened by the DNC in order to abandon his lifelong principles of socialism and endorse Hillary Clinton? Or was he bought off? You know, they give him a golden parachute or maybe a Goldman Sachs parachute. Is that where he came up with the $600,000 to buy a second home? You know, here you go, Bernie. Champagne wishes and caviar dreams. This is a four-bedroom, 500-foot beachfront on Lake Champlain, okay? It's on the east side of the island facing Vermont and not New York. And when I look at this, okay, this is Let me read you some of the tweets these people have. Man of the people, Bernie Sanders, buys a $600,000 second summer home in Vermont. Another one. The socialist now has a summer home. LOL. Y'all got clowned as always. Another one. When you find out Bernie Sanders just used your $27 donations to buy himself a new summer home. Look, he was praising Daniel Ortega and the Sandinistas. Remember that 30-year-old video when he went down there? He just couldn't say enough nice things about them. But you understand what Daniel Ortega and the Sandinistas did. I've been calling him this whole campaign Bernie Sandernista, okay? And actually, I heard some of the Sanders people at the DNC calling themselves Sandinistas. Daniel Ortega was a thief. He was a kleptocrat. He stole all the private property from people, and as he was being driven out by a coalition of lefties and righties, he then privatized that again for himself. We saw the same thing happening with Hugo Chavez. They work for the bankers. Hugo Chavez gave them 700% return on their investment. Now we've got Bernie Sanders with a brand new $600,000. Welcome back to our final segment of the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host. Before I get back to the news, I just want to remind you that this is the last chance for free shipping store-wide at InfoWarsStore.com. It is going to end in the next 24 hours. We had told you yesterday it was going to go for another 42 hours, and so we're now down to about 24 hours. But you can still take advantage of this to get some of the off-the-grid preparedness items that we sell at InfoWarsStore.com. Here's a couple of examples and also additional sales that we have. The Premium Power Pack, we have 20% off. And, of course, this is something you can use to even start your car. I've actually done that myself. We had a car that we intentionally left the lights on because we were doing some work outside and ran the battery down because it's getting kind of old. And we were able to easily jumpstart that with that little tiny box. It's invaluable. That's a really handy thing to have available for you, especially, you know, if you're a woman and you're concerned about being stranded on the side of the road and how that might expose you to some safety issues. Just carry that little tiny box with you and you can restart that car. Also, if you want to get started on solar power, we have the solar base station that is now 33% off at InfoWarsStore.com. So those are a couple of the specials there, as well as store-wide free shipping at InfoWarsStore.com. And, of course, we have this breaking story that I mentioned earlier from Mikhail Phelan. WikiLeaks is now offering a $20,000 reward for information on a murdered DNC staffer. There have been three people linked to the DNC who have died under questionable circumstances since these email leaks that affected the DNC. And, of course, we've had a lot of people die under questionable circumstances with Hillary Clinton. Darren McBreen is working on a report right now with that. There's so many, as a matter of fact, to try to cut it down to the biggest ones is the problem. And, of course, this guy who died, Seth Rich, it was immediately pronounced by the D.C. police chief, Kathy Lanier, who never met a gun control law she didn't want to enforce and extend. She immediately said, well, I think this is a robbery. Yet, they didn't touch his wallet. They didn't touch his watch. They didn't take his phone. Nothing was taken from him. He was just beaten and shot. So WikiLeaks is not buying it. They want, they're offering a $20,000 reward for information about his murder. Now, in other news, we have a question by the New American. They ask, could an increase in gun ownership impact the election? This is a very interesting way to look at this. This is a John Lott's organization who said, during President Obama's administration, the number of concealed handgun permits has soared to over 14.5 million, a 215% increase since 2007. More than 6% of the adult population now has a permit to carry concealed. Do you want to lose that right that you just newly discovered, folks? Because you will if Hillary Clinton gets elected. She will appoint judges all up and down, not just in the Supreme Court, but she'll appoint judges everywhere to do everything she can to shut down your right to keep and bear arms. And they pointed out this from the Heritage Foundation. They also noted that the swing states have the biggest increase in the number of permits. Florida, for example, has 1.6 million, while Pennsylvania has 1.2. Ohio, Michigan, North Carolina each have more than 500,000. Indiana has nearly 750,000. These are all states that were carried by Obama in at least one of his last two elections. But then on the other hand, we have the federal civilian workforce has soared to 2.79 million just recently. We've had a massive uptick in the bureaucracy. You know who those people are going to be voting for. And don't forget, when you look at this and you look at where we're headed, the disruptive technologies that are coming towards us, you're worried about the DNC hacks. Worry about them hacking your transportation. As I pointed out last night on the Nightly News, these hacks that they're demonstrating at DEF CON and Black Hat Conference, one of them, with just off-the-shelf components, with just a fish depth finder, they could completely blind a Tesla car. Turn it into, as a guy who sent it to me said, turn it into Helen Keller on a NASCAR track. Join us tonight for the InfoWars Nightly News, 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern.